big time movie star, recurring artist, very funny comedian. Jamie Foxx is on his way out.
Hey, anybody want some of this?
Jamie Foxx is one of the baddest.
Because brothers can't never give you your full problem.
I told Jamie he was going to be famous.
Jamie Foxx, you could act.
Jamie Foxx, he's got the voice, he's got the looks, he's got everything. I mean, it's unbelievable.
We like the party. Who likes the party, man?
Listen, Lord.
Winning dramatic actor.
We've been blessed with the opportunity to have a drama lane.
Comedian with hits on the big and small screen.
It's hard to believe the guy in the screen is the same goofball I see the comic book.
I'm the innovator and the motivator, the originator of this stuff.
And a chart-topping sexy singer.
May I say it, Jamie? You have the voice of an angel.
Winning actor, he's a multi-platinum recording artist, Grammy nominated singer, critic, stand-up comic.
So you're just taking over show business, apparently, huh?
You know, I'm doing my best.
And the Oscar goes to
Jamie Foxx!
Jamie Foxx! Please welcome Jamie Foxx.
Jamie Foxx!
Jamie Foxx.
The next president of the United States, Jamie Foxx.
Yeah, say that one more time.
Once again, Jamie Foxx, comedy legend, Jamie Foxx!
Hey, you know what? I'm gonna make a do with a do, baby.
Yo, what? Wait, yo, we're back.
Oh.
We're here, Friday the Fox.
Hey, what's going on?
Hey,
we need better interns.
Shout out to the producers.
I mean, producers.
Welcome to the Foxhole. Yeah, it's our new theme song.
None of us knows the words, though.
Johnny Mac, can you hand me my house shoes?
Where my loafs at?
Here's a little something about a brother like me. Never should have been let out the penitentiary.
DMX.
Ice Cube would like to say that I'm a crazy motherfucker from around the way.
Shout out to Roger
Clemens. Since I was a youth, I smoked weed out. Now I'm a motherfucker that you read about. Taking my life for two. That's what the hell I do.
You don't like the Foxhole.
Who's dicks only?
And I'm in it, man. I don't mess with me. You're in a minute with the right, left, right, left, right. You mother. That's a god darn name, Brooklyn.
Nigga, you sound like NWA's accountant.
Oh my god.
Yo, cut it.
Too busy.
I'd like to thank Louis Dick for fucking up our intro.
But it was funny to see him try to.
He's not in NWA, he's in CPA.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
CPA.
You don't know a CPA? Of course he doesn't. Public. He didn't come for that.
He's never had a CPA. Yo, do a quick roll call here at Foxhole, Series 106, XM 149. Who we got in the house?
My name's Chris Spencer.
That's it?
Spencer.
I ain't got no nickname.
Spencer.
42, two kids. I just came because my wife is home right now.
Sure. And she made you wear that bright shirt.
Wow.
Okay, you done fucked up the intro and the song.
To say
over here, we got my girl, 10 grand.
It's C. Murder.
Claudia Jordan.
Hi. That's my real name, Claudia Jordan. Hi, everybody.
Sure, you're great energy.
I'm good. Yeah, I'm good.
Came right in to C. Murder. We can get the real name.
Well, Claudia Jordan.
There you go.
I say that, then you say you want the other one. I say, you know, which one would you
You look great.
Thank you.
I love this part because you always, always look nice.
And the cat didn't make it. The cat was put to sleep Tuesday night.
I was going to say, pass me the soap.
Well, Lewis, you should have came with me because that could have been the first time you actually killed the pussy.
Over here, we got my man, 10 grand.
Happy Foxhole Friday to you, Johnny Mac and C Murder. TDP, Mr. 123 Knox.
Baby. I love that song. We was on the bus. We was going to Vegas.
Oh, my God.
You did that?
Hilarious.
Sir.
Great time. And until Claudia got mad and.
I got mad?
Yeah, you was mad at the other girl that got on. We get to that later.
She took a Viking in.
Yeah.
Well, she was mad at the other
person. She fucked a Viking. One of the two. Over here, my man, 10 grand after 16, 17 years.
Yo, what's up? It's your boy Speedy. Want to say what's happening to the big girls out there.
Yeah, they don't want to hear that.
Yes, it is.
Is it politically correct to call them big girls?
Yes,
I don't
it
think
is
we should be able to call.
You don't call them fat.
I think that's an insult to no, call them big girls.
You call them drive-through queens.
Oh, she got them out today, my girl.
Bitties in your mouth.
OG poetess.
Rehab every day. How's the rehab thing going?
Forget about it. What's that, Louis Dix?
Oh, you quit?
Are you quit?
I'm working rehab on it.
You quit? You working on quitting or you working on?
you got to commit to either quit or just be a weed head.
John, this
I mean, I mean, it's hard.
Yeah, this is how I go to weed bags on the table. She's like, no,
I think I can. I think I can.
When you know, I had people in SAC come up talking about bonus. I got that purple. You know, I turned it down. Gave it.
Yeah, I don't blame you. You don't really know what somebody else might have on it. And over here, we got the most hated man in radio.
That's not true. It's Louis Dix. You all know you.
Fistix
in your mouth. I told y'all that's nasty. That sounds like I do that, and I don't do that.
You do that.
I don't do that. I don't do that. I like fish sticks.
I was going to say, you don't eat fish sticks?
I eat fish sticks.
But you don't swallow.
I eat the fish. No, I eat fish sticks.
You ever put a fish stick in your mouth?
No, no, don't go there. I don't, I've never put a fish that in my mouth.
You put a fish stick, but you just don't swallow.
So you like the fish is batter, but you just don't like it in your mouth.
So you like the tartar sauce.
It's obvious I'm not going to win this, but fish sticks.
See, fish sticks in your mouth.
Y'all heard about this whole Dr. Laura thing. What? Now she's quitting her show. She's not going to come back after, you know, the, she's not going to be re-signed.
Good.
And she was really upset about what went down, and they say that there was another caller waiting on the line after Jade.
What?
First name Johnny, last name Mac, middle name motherfucker. I heard this black ass nigga had a bone to pick with her, and his name is Johnny motherfucking Mac.
Well, you know what? I'm going to just jump right into it. We're just going to jump right into the topic.
Yeah.
And it's going to sound really weird.
8772.
Can we play the clip again? Do we need to play the clip again?
I don't really have
to. Do we need to play that again? I don't think she should have. Okay, let's play the clip again.
I'm black.
And pay attention to the end of the clip.
All the way we've been around some of his friends and family members who start make racist comments as if I'm not there or if I'm not black. And my husband ignores those comments, and it hurts my feelings. And then he just acts like he
Can you give me an example of a racist comment? Because sometimes people are hypersensitive. So tell me give me two good examples of racist comments.
Okay, last night, good example. We had a neighbor come over, and this neighbor, every time he comes over, it's always black comment. It's, oh, well, how do you black people like doing this, and do black people really like doing that? And for a long time, I would ignore it. But last night, I got to the point
where I don't think that's racist.
The stereotype.
I don't think that's racist. No, I think that, no. I think that's, well, listen, without giving much thought, a lot of blacks voted for Obama simply because he was half black. No. Didn't matter what he was going to do in office. It was a black thing.
Wow.
You got to know that. That's not a surprise. Not everything that somebody says. We had friends over the other day, got about 35 people here. The guys were going to start playing basketball. I was going to go out and play basketball. My bodyguard and my dear friend is a black man. And I said, white men can't jump. I want you on my team. That was racist? That was funny.
How about the N-word, though? The N-word's been thrown around.
Black guys use it all the time. Turn on HBO, listen to a black comic, and all you hear is nigger, nigger, nigger. I don't get it. If anybody without enough melanin says it, it's a horrible thing. But when black people say it, it's affectionate. It's very confusing. Dolores Lessing, you're talking to Jade. What did you think about during the break, by the way?
I was a little caught back by the N-word that you spewed out, I have to be honest with you. But my point is race relations.
Oh, then I guess you don't watch HBO or listen to any black comedians.
But that doesn't make it right. I mean, race is a big
my
thing.
Dear... My Obama's dear, the point I'm trying to make
to another level that's unacceptable.
Yeah, we got a black man as president, and we have more complaining about racism than ever. I mean, I think that's hilarious.
But I think, honestly, because there's more white people afraid of a black man taking over the nation.
They're afraid.
If you want to be honest about it.
Dear, they voted him in. Only 12% of the population's black. Whites voted him in.
It was the younger generation that did it. It wasn't the older white people who did it.
Okay. All right. All right. Chip on your shoulder. I can't do much about that. Yeah. I think you have too much sensitivity and not enough sense of humor. Well, it depends how it's said.
Is it okay to say that word? Is it ever okay to say that word?
It depends how it's said. Black guys talking to each other seem to think it's okay.
But you're not black. They're not black.
Oh, I see. So a word is restricted to race. Got it. Can't do much about that.
I can't believe someone like you is on the radio spewing out the nigger word, and I hope everybody
I didn't
heard it.
Spew out the nigger word.
Nigger, nigger, nigger.
And right. I said that's what you hear.
Heard it.
Yes, they did.
I hope everybody heard it. So what
they did, and I'll say it again. Nigger, nigger, nigger is what you hear on HB. Why don't you let me finish a sentence?
Okay.
Don't take things out of context. Don't double NAACP me. Leave them in context.
I know what it means, and I know it came from a white person, and I know the white person made
it
bad.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Wow.
Can't have this argument. You know what? If you're that hypersensitive about color and don't have a sense of humor, don't marry out of your race.
There it is.
There it is right there. That's the reason why.
That's why your ass in trouble.
That's why she should have got in trouble. It was a whole lot of things that she said that wasn't cool.
But you had one funny joke.
First of all,
the joke was funny about
it. When you seen a black HBO special? What was the last one you saw?
Chris Spencer's.
1995. What, you know what I'm saying?
She's very obnoxious.
Well, here's my thing. And I want everybody to weigh in this, you know, one at a time. You know, I'm going to start with Lou Diggs. Do you think she should... No, I don't want to start with Lou Diggs. I want to start with Chris. Do you think she should have quit or been fired?
Absolutely not.
Okay, now go ahead. Weigh in on the Chris.
I think all she did... She's not like she called anybody a nigger.
She called me one.
She
said comedians.
No, she said comedians on Def Jam or HBO use the word nigger. Correct. Right. She said that.
Right. And Speedy, you've been on neither one of those shows. But keep going, Chris.
She meant working comedians.
Yes, I am.
Working comedians.
Go ahead, Chris.
When Comic V was in Gardena, you said the word nigger.
Still.
I did too. So for her to quote the word nigger, to say that somebody else said it, I don't see anything wrong. Had she done with what Imus did, right, then I think we have reason to debate what she's talking about.
Right.
The only thing I didn't like is how she had to hit the word black every time.
Yeah, when
black comedians, black, you know what I mean?
Just say nigga?
Just say black.
Oh, okay.
She said black, but she was putting too much emphasis.
She italicized it. Yeah. It was in bold.
It was.
She tweeted it. Claudia, how do you feel? You think she should have lost
her tweet?
You think she
Twitter king.
I'm real sensitive about Twitter. Anyways, no, I don't think she should have quit. I feel like that shows that she's a coward. I feel like she's using that as an excuse to get a bigger and better deal later on, going the Don Imus route, take a little time out, and get a little sympathy from equally obnoxious people such as Sarah Palin. And, she's now turning herself into the victim now. I think she's an idiot.
Speedy, how do you feel? Weigh in on that, Speedy.
Well, I gave my point last week, which is I'm not using the word nigga no more. But I think
And he's already up to $40
but
with me.
I think the point that we're missing is what she said at the end, which was she told the young lady, you shouldn't have married out of your race.
Right.
And I think that's the key, and that's the straw, I think, that really broke the camel's back. 877-2106-106 is the number to call into to give your opinion.
And Speedy,
well,
I appreciate the fact that you're not using the word nigga anymore, but obviously you're still using your knife and fork. But anyway, we're going to go to Lou Diggs. This nigga gaining weight as we speak.
As I've said before, I've been a fan of Dr. Laura for over 15 years, and I think I stand on her side. I think that she made a good point. It wasn't received well by everyone, but she was... Listen, the girl had issues in her own family.
The question is, should she have quit or resigned?
No, she shouldn't have quit. She shouldn't have quit.
That's the question.
But the girl was saying that her husband and her family were ignoring all these racist comments, but now she comes on Dr. Laura, and all of a sudden Dr. Laura's trying to make a point to her, and now she runs. She was on Larry King sweating it. So my point is this. If she couldn't handle what she was supposed to handle in her own home, because yesterday she said on Larry King that her husband is supporting her now. He's so supportive, but he was the same guy that was calling her names and everything.
Well, I'm not going to say she was handling it because of the across the street neighbors or the neighbors, whoever, is coming over calling her niggas and whatever.
And the family and friends.
And the family and friends. I think the husband should have stood up. And more importantly, she should have stood up. She should say, look, hunkies, all you motherfuckers, stay outside.
Family.
Stay outside my house. That's how it should have been.
But listen,
and then we should have got right into it.
Were they calling her names, or were they just kind of according to her?
Black people do this.
Oh, they called her.
Why do you black people do that? Play basketball, not take care of your kids.
We got our first caller. We got my man from Texas. We got Marcus from Texas. Weigh in on him, Marcus.
Yo, what's up, man?
What's up, man?
I feel like, you know what I'm saying, she wasn't all the way black. You know what I'm saying? Like, real black people wouldn't never let that shit slide at home anyway. You know what I'm saying? And then on top of that, they probably would have came up to the studio and handled that with her. I don't think she should have said everything that she said, but I wouldn't have quit my job. You know what I'm saying?
Right. After saying 11 niggas, you gotta quit.
Yeah, nigga.
Not really. I don't know.
You're on the right track, Marcus. You're on the right track.
Well, it wasn't.
She didn't call anybody any names.
She didn't.
Right. Yeah, she didn't call her a nigga. But my thing is, like with Speedy, is that when she said you shouldn't marry it outside your race,
that's
if you couldn't
one.
Handle it. I can't have, if I married in my race, and I can't have no white person come in my house and say, hey, nigga, how do you eat your watermelon? Hey, you like your fried chicken, nigga? I mean, that has nothing to do with the marriage. I think that whoever the neighbors was disrespecting the marriage, disrespecting her and the husband. You won't be my friend that long if you keep coming over and insulting my wife and my children. I don't know if they got kids or not, but I'm just throwing it
probably
all in there.
Probably.
Then you shouldn't be my friend. The husband is the coward. He should have stepped up from the beginning and bust a white motherfucker in his nose for calling his wife a nigga. Only one should be able to call his wife a nigga is him.
Right. And they have to be naked.
Well, that's his nigga.
We got another phone call
TDP.
We got another phone call from Tennessee. We got my man, is this MJ? MJ from Tennessee.
Hey, Johnny Mac, how's it going?
Hey, what's going on, MJ?
What's happening, dog? What's up?
Hey, I was just calling in regard to the Dr. Laurie comment. I hate to say this on live radio, but I have to agree with Lou Dix. It's being blown up way out of proportion. I'm going to tell you the simple reason why. The real root of the problem is there has not been any time in history where white America was prohibited for not saying or doing anything. So mm-hmm. this is the big issue. They keep asking, why is it different for them to not say it as well as we can say it within the comforts of around our own people? So it's getting to the point that white America is kind of getting frustrated about this because they saying that if we can say it, how come they can't say it?
Mm-hmm. Well, they the ones started it.
Well,
I understand what he's saying.
The question is, why do they want to say it?
That, there you go.
Because we don't want them to.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna let.
What I was gonna say.
They can say it. Just duck.
Say it in the drive-by, nigga. Paul, that's how you feel about it.
Thank you.
I was just gonna say one of the comments that stood out to me that she said, "You guys got a black president, and there's more racism than ever." It's just that I think a lot of people's true colors are coming out.
Yeah. I agree.
And because they're upset that there's a black president, so a lot of it is harder to hide now. It's always been there. It isn't that there's more racism. It's always been there, but people are just more out front with it now.
And also, too, to tag with that.
Hold on. I need.
Oh,
okay,
well,
go ahead.
Just to tag on that.
Okay,
is when she said that we only voted for the president because we were black.
Yeah, we have no thought
process. I voted for him because he wasn't Bush. TDP, how you feel about it?
I just want to know, did Dr. Laura say it enough to have her teeth white?
What did you say?
Nigga.
You know.
Teeth white.
Paul Mooney. Oh. Threw me right on off.
Yeah, it was Lewis Dix moment right there.
And so, in other words, she's kind of saying, you guys got a black president. Why are you still complaining?
I like how they act like they gave us the president.
Right.
Like, it's only 15 of y'all. It was us who gave him to you, so be happy.
Okay, Claudia?
I just wanted to point out an inconsistency in our media that I'm really sensitive to this. You know, Barack Obama called the reporter sweetie one time, and it was news for 2 weeks on CNN and actually on Fox News. It was news that he disrespected this woman by calling her sweetie. He should apologize. Dr. Laura says nigga 11 times. I don't think she should lose her show, but there is an issue to be made about her, you know, and these people wanted to use this word. So it's like the inconsistency that we judge public officials is so inconsistent.
Well, I like what the caller said, which was, now they're having a problem because we're telling them something they can't do. And right. They've been able to do it all their life. They've been able to walk up to niggas and call them niggas.
Not really.
I mean, in the 60s,
70s. I went to an all-black continuation high school. We talking about that.
And how many years did you continue in?
I'm still going there.
How many years were you doing, Johnny Mac?
As opposed to all white.
I'm going to go with Chris Spencer. Why do you want to say it? I don't want to say nothing to a white person that's going to incite them to a riot or make them fuss and fight. Why do I want to say it?
I don't want to call a gay person a fag. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It, you know, if you want to say it, say it in the confines.
You just did.
No, he says,
are you gay?
I'm saying you said the word.
No, I'm saying I can say the word, but why do I want to say it to that person? Gotcha. Why would I want to hurt
that person?
Why
are you fighting for the right to say that?
Right.
Like, there's some really agitating words that you can say to Jewish folks, and I don't want to open those wounds to them because I know there's some things they're sensitive about. So I wouldn't fight for the right to be able to, you know, to make those comments. Plus, I also want to work in Hollywood.
But, yeah, I just don't get, why do you want to say it? Why? I don't understand, why do you want to say it? Why would you want to take the chance that it might incite me to anger, which it really will? It's going to make me, we was at the show in Sac last weekend, which was a great show. I appreciate everybody in Sacramento that came out and supported everything we did. It was a lovely, lovely occasion, lovely event. But, Speedy, I think, was it Speedy? Somebody asked, there was some Asian dudes there. They say the word nigga, when black people? They say, oh yeah,
John,
we say the word nigga all the time. And I've been with my homies and we say nigga, and I just got extremely
mad.
And I was like, my man, let me help you out.
You didn't have shrimp fried rice for a week.
Don't fucking say that word in front of me.
Right.
And he's like, you know what? Well, I be with my homies. I'm going to whoop you and all your motherfucking homies right now. I was just about to get ugly, and Speedy grabbed me by my coattail and said, Johnny Mac, just have a seat. Because that word, people die for that word. While we loosely use it right now, and it means so much, whatever, people die for that word.
Yeah, but you say that in one
hand. Hold on for a second. People die for that word. To give you the freedom to say what you about to say right now,
are you
black people sit at a counter just so they can eat in a restaurant.
Okay, so why?
So people die for that. No matter how you feel, Lou Dix, people die.
But let me make my point. Why do you go around freely saying it in mixed company if it means so much to you? Use it privately. Mm. That's my argument. If it means that much and people die, then let's honor the people people at the counter and stop saying it to people who are now taking it and using it the way
you. Well, nigga, you can't tell me what to do.
I agree. I don't think we should say it in front of company. I agree with that.
Yeah.
We got another phone call. I agree with that, too. We got
saying it ever again.
We got another
he
phone
said
call.
Six times tonight so far.
Okay.
Today.
Oh.
Okay, we got another phone call on the line. We got my man, Tony. What's up, Tony?
Hey, what's happening, Foxhole? Hey,
what's going on with it?
Hey, I'm calling from California. Hey, first off, all black folks is in the same family. We all in the same family. So if I call my sister a bitch, that's one thing. Mm. But if Speedy called my sister a bitch, me and Speedy got issues. I think it's the same with black folks
like
and
that
word. And the word nigga. Now, hear this. When it comes to Dr. Laura, her saying the word nigga did not really offend me because the word nigga exists.
Right.
For her not to say it, it's almost like it don't exist. What I got offended at was, I mean, she's exposed as the racist she is. I think she should stay on radio so we all have that example to point to. The other thing is that when she said, don't NAACP me, is what make me want to find her and choke her.
Yeah,
right.
That was completely rude and completely out of line. That's the comment I think that needs to be on the front page.
Do you think we give the word too much power?
Nope.
By protesting it, by bringing this issue up, do we give that word too much
power?
It has
a lot of power.
You know what? I'm going to agree with Lou Dix. You know,
again?
Not with his outfit, just what he said. Maybe we shouldn't use
Thank
it
the phone
in,
call,
in the midst of mixed company. I mean, maybe, you know, amongst ourselves, you know what I'm saying? Because it's like a term of endearment, like Speedy's my nigga. Like, what up, nigga? We do that to Chris Spencer. But if we surround it, if I'm over across the street to our little eating establishment, it's like only three black people in there. Right. I shouldn't be saying nigga and then the motherfucker nigga.
But you do,
but
Johnny
you do, John. And
you
I cringe. I cringe.
Are y'all trying to throw me under the bus?
Yes, I'm going to throw you under the bus.
What kind of niggas are y'all?
Come on, Johnny Mac. When they don't give you your Tabasco sauce, you go nigga crazy. Yeah.
You do, Johnny Mac.
John, no, but he's saying he shouldn't.
You do.
I say we should not.
But you use it more than mostly anybody.
Okay, it's not an attack on Johnny Mac.
No, it's not an attack on you. I'm just keeping it real.
All three of y'all just attacked me.
Nigga, listen.
I'm going to find some new niggas. Apparently ain't my niggas. We got another phone call from Texas. Tammy from Texas. Hey, Tammy.
Hey, boo, hey. How's it going?
Hey, how's it going, love?
She said boo.
It's going good. Hey, you know what? Why does everybody give that word nigga so much power?
Your daughter, too.
Your daughter got to
nigger. That's my baby sitting here. Nigger basically means ignorance. So you got ignorant people in every way. Yeah. Every race.
That's on the phone, you know, with six kids at the same time. You're right.
That's all you.
You're not stupid. That's all me. That's all me. But you know what?
I had a great deal.
Hang on now. You want what you got? No. But you got ignorant ass white people. But instead of saying ignorant ass white people, you just call them a nigger. I do it all the damn time. It ain't no big thing to me at all to call them a nigger. But when I call you a nigger, you can best believe that I'm telling you that your ass is ignorant. If I call you a nigger, then you can be a homie.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, get you a car seat.
So is the
you put them niggers in.
So is the solution to this? Is the solution to take?
Go ahead.
To start calling white people nigger and not make it be a black thing?
No.
It'll always
be a black thing.
In the dictionary, it isn't a black thing.
It'll always be a black thing. Come on,
ignorant. No, I'm saying in the dictionary.
No, it doesn't.
With the word it's supposed to be.
Well, no, so is gay. And what does that mean in the dictionary?
Happy.
Oh. Happy.
Louis Dix.
And strange. We're going to take a quick break and come right back.
Skinny jeans is what it means.
And anybody, we want you to call into 877-2106-106 and weigh in. We love to hear your comments. We're going to take a quick break right now. Foxhole Series 106 XM 149. Yo, we're back. We're back. I just had to cut Kevin Hart off. It was a phone call from Kevin Hart. I had to cut him off. Right,
it was short.
But he ain't got no movie. He ain't got no movie out.
Oh, wow. You had to cut him short.
When y'all start.
Yeah, he only had a little time left. We're going to go to Lou Dix with the BMW.
Hey, it's Lou Dix. And as you know, the Foxhole crew has become my second family since my divorce.
Not.
Yeah, so yes. Thank you all. Yeah,
we love you, Lou Dix.
And we're always rolling in the new luxury home on wheels, the BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo. Now, sitting in this car is like sitting in your favorite lounge with my boys, TDP, Johnny Mac, Speedy.
I would never be in a car with you.
And Chris Spencer. Come on, y'all would. We wouldn't be sitting close. But listen, we're watching the Eagles beat up on the Cowboys. Sorry, Cowboys. The BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo is on point. You can't beat the details, exclusive materials, outstanding craftsmanship inside the BMW 5 Series, a second to none, just like the Foxhole crew. Now, you guys wouldn't watch a game with me, seriously?
No.
No,
because
Chris would. What?
What's your team? What's your football
the
team?
The Eagles, baby.
Oh.
But, are they still playing?
They're all
oh, they got rid of McNabb. I can't roll with them. They got rid of the brother.
Oh, they got rid of your little fat quarterback too.
No, he had a baby, so
he's out on maternity leave right now. Yeah, he's giving his syrup right now.
Send him on the scissor. Okay, we gotta go. Porter, yeah. You look really nice and summery. You got the calves out.
The bitties.
You got
out.
The breast area nice and exposed. I respect that.
It's like a sexual predator, a little bit.
Oh, right.
She looks uncomfortable.
Like she lotioned her ankles.
She looks uncomfortable.
My ankles are lotioned.
Apparently, it's cold in here.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Oh, Speedy, your nipples are up.
Yeah, both your nipples are up.
Yeah, Porter, like she got two baby big toes on her shirt.
Oh, my God. No, that's Speedy. Big shout out to Bud Light. With superior drinkability, that just right taste, not too heavy, not too light. I can use a Bud Light right now, and the unique ability to elevate good times with friends. Bud Light is fun, social, and the perfect beer for bringing people together.
Bringing nipples together.
Oh my God! Bud Light's drinkability, that just right taste.
Bud Light bottle caps.
Not too heavy, not too light, is what sets Bud Light apart from other light beers. It's the sure sign of a good time. The just right taste.
Yes. Yes. Taste. Move your nipple out of the way.
Here we go.
You ever pour a Bud Light over? I'm just saying.
POTUS, I got a really good lawyer for sexual harassment.
It ain't
call at me after the show.
You didn't get paid for it.
Yes, I did.
Ain't got shit.
That's true.
I can't sue. Never mind.
Hey, but on the Bud Light, I do drink. I'm going to let the Bud Light people know I'm rerunning short on the lime right now. We need a whole new couple of more cases.
I love the Bud Light.
Can I say something?
Yes.
The yellow dude wants some lime.
Can I say something? This going to fuck you up.
What?
I don't know if it's stole, but I actually took two cases of the Bud Light Lime to the crib. Don't look at me like that, King. You knew I had a criminal record. I got in this motherfucker.
That is
all that shit in the back. Of course I'm going to take a few home.
That is poor judgment on his behalf, actually.
Yeah,
he ain't lock it up or nothing.
Thank you, Speedy.
He does hire criminals.
Thank you. I did take two cases to the crib.
I took four.
Like, you know what's funny? I did
child support. I gave that to the baby mama.
Wow,
I said, go on, take this Bud Light. She said, cool.
Cool.
Wow.
Next week,
and
have my money.
I got them in my refrigerator. I don't really have groceries. I just buy food as I go. But I got at least 7 Bud Light Limes
and
in
salt.
There. And salt. I got 2 boxes of salt.
No food for the host?
What?
He don't feed no host.
By the time they get there,
wow.
They got something else they can eat.
Oh, dick sandwich. That is not. Chivalry should not be dead.
They got this tube steak smothered in underwear gravy they can go on and chew on.
Oh, my God.
I can't wait to see the day that you and Speedy both settle
Never.
Down. Not together, but settle down.
Hey. My man.
You don't want to settle down like your cat.
Oh. It's too soon, Speedy. My cat just died.
Bud Light joke of the day.
I heard,
you know, I'm sorry that
That's
the cat died.
My cat died.
Yeah, man, let me pour a little bit for the cats who aren't here.
This is some crazy.
Oh, God.
My meow in that gangster lane. Why'd you have to go? Did you have a funeral for the cat? Before we get into that.
That's a cold cat.
We're going to get right into the cat. We're going to get right into
that.
You
guys ain't right.
But I got a very special guest.
Y'all
man.
Need to paw.
That's hysterical. I got a very special friend.
Is he special?
He's a very good friend of mine. I work with this cat. Love this cat,
hey.
Man.
Can't get his party, though.
You know what I'm saying? He can't get into his party.
Unless he's skinny with a backpack.
The nigga always give me mad love.
Got funny.
I come through. The motherfucker let me in his party for free.
What's
get
up,
some
man?
Drinks, the whole get down. Got a new movie coming out right now. Lottery ticket.
It's
Are you the star of that movie?
No.
Okay, cool. Bow Wow is. Come on.
Oh, wow.
Well, we want to give a warm welcome.
Jesus.
Yeah, we starting right now.
Let him go. Oh,
yeah, no, come on.
I got to introduce
go.
You first.
All right, we
give it up
right
for
now.
My man, Brandon T. Jackson.
What's up? Yeah.
Welcome
What's up,
to
y'all?
The show.
Is the mustache and Sammy Sam talking now?
Yosemite
Sam.
No, Brandon.
I can't do it.
You know,
I can't do it with you.
Brandon,
I just can't.
You know we love you, but seriously, we see Bow Wow. Say, Mama, that you're not playing that
role. It's cool, though. It's cool, though.
Which role are you, Brandon?
I'm in the movies. Like, the one where the film is rolling. The one where the film is rolling.
He said it with an S. So you're saying Louis Dix is in the movies?
No, he is.
Well, there's no warm-up for films.
Oh,
I'm just saying.
Oh,
yeah,
that's
man.
Funny.
That's funny.
Like, you'll see for 3 weeks, nigga.
Brandon T, let's talk a little bit.
No, the movie's good. It's actually pretty good. It ain't bad.
Let's talk about your movie.
I mean, it's lottery ticket.
You trying to convince us or yourself?
You're like, you don't sound too convincing.
I mean, it's cool. I mean, it's good.
I mean, if you like Caught Up.
No, my
if you like Death at a Funeral, yeah.
Maybe you like All About the Benjamins. The same ticket.
It's a pretty good movie.
Talk about the movie. Tell us about it.
I mean, Bow Wow.
Co-star
wins $370 million, and everybody can try to come out there in the project. The thing is this, though, he can't cash a ticket until after the weekend is over because it's a 4th of July weekend.
Right.
So, but the thing is, the movie is actually a pretty good movie. I mean, my thing is, I'm sick of looking at, like, reviews, and it's like, I look
what
at...
What they say?
No, it's just always that race. It's like racism always, and they always put our movies to the side. You know
they
what
called
mean?
Your movie a nigga?
No, they didn't.
It's a lot of niggas in this movie.
I wish they did, though. There's
11 niggas in that movie.
But they might as well. I'm looking at Variety Days, The Vampires Suck, Nanny McPhee, Piranha 3D, then we got Lottery Ticket. We got less theaters, and he says, this was Brandon T. Jackson and Bow Wow, Warner Brothers Comedy, Lottery Ticket, which is tracking well.
Right.
With African Americans.
Oh, that's a good thing.
No.
We like lottery tickets.
That's a good thing.
Yes, we do. It's going to be a good movie, but I'm just saying that they always put our movies to the side. I just hate it. You know what I mean? I just hate it. They always put ours off to the side.
Well, you don't want to put a lottery ticket right up with the Gladiator, nigga. I mean, let's be honest.
No, but you do want to put it where, right? Listen,
shit,
white.
I'm not even in the movie.
More white kids see this movie than anything else. See, this.
But here's the thing, Brandon.
They always trying to keep it separate, though.
Do we care who sees it, long as it's being people seeing it?
Now when Vampire Sucks got 3,000 theaters and we got 1,900 theaters.
Okay, now.
Why is that? Now they choose a way, place.
Well,
we
Louis Dick Sucks ain't got no theater.
But listen, Brandon.
We're talking
Brandon.
About racism in Hollywood.
Brandon, don't you think, given where your name is on the credits, you should let Bow Wow have this argument?
Ooh.
Oh, my God.
You know, so you can, like, pace your career.
How about you go see the film first?
I know.
See, I'm a pirate, son. I'm Jack Sparrow, dude. Like, go see the movie.
I'm not dissing you.
Just watch the movie.
I think you're a very talented young man. Don't get me wrong. Really, I think you're gifted.
Not really.
No, he is. No, I think you're out of town. No, I think film-wise, I think
no, y'all old niggas making it harder for us.
Oh,
cool.
Shit.
That's cool.
Damn.
No, we're not making it harder.
I thought you were really funny in Tropic Thunder.
Thank you, man.
Really?
Oh,
I watched that movie a lot
of
times.
I thought when you slapped my man back, that was great
that
timing.
Was cool.
That was
cool. It was a white movie, right?
And I saw Percy Jackson. I saw that, too.
The white movie. Yeah.
I thought you was good in Rolls.
It's not a white
State.
Movie. It's a movie.
Thank you.
When you did Cornbread Earl and Me, I thought your levels were just there.
Thank you.
Cornbread Earl and Me.
I'm happy you said that. It's just a movie, right?
Right.
So why do they always got to put our movies off to the side? Because white kids love me and Bow the same.
Were you complaining
not
when you got when you
really.
Doing this complaining when you first got your first break? That's what I'm annoyed at.
You
should
be happy. First,
well,
you
know? Well, the point he's
he
making.
He started complaining when he started getting back in.
Oh, wow.
That makes sense.
Okay. What happened?
Well, so you started getting back in, so these are the kind of questions you need to ask.
Well, no, I'm just asking because I grew up in a white neighborhood, and like I was homecoming king every year in a row. So they
really?
Can't. Yes.
You're the homecoming king.
My
at,
thing is
at Burger King.
Did you play? Did you play sports?
No, I didn't play no sports. I was
what?
Cool.
So you just were an
no,
actor?
I played basketball.
Ho. You didn't play no sports?
I played basketball 2 years in a row, and I became
okay.
a comic.
Okay.
You wait, 2 years in a row.
What are you getting to relate to?
Because I don't trust no dude that ain't play shit. I don't trust a dude that didn't play any sports.
No.
Did you let her? Did
you
let her?
You got a pink sport? Shirt on.
Did you let her in a sport in high school?
Don't start with him, Brandon.
Yeah, not with that shirt on, nigga.
They got the Beatles shirt on. What's wrong with that?
Yeah, that's said enough.
You got Scooby-Doo lifting weights.
But you got it in a size 4 toddler.
Nigga, look how short your shirt is.
This is a large. That's
you got
Johnny Mac. This
is
a Bow Wow collection.
You got a sports bra on, nigga. No.
Well,
that'd have been funny on stage.
You got a sports bra.
In 93, that would have killed.
Oh, it says pump up. This nigga doing a shake with Shamar Moore and you know that new shake? Him and Tyler Perry doing that in the back.
Oh.
Get the shake.
You won't be in that movie.
Going back to what he said, I understand what you're
you
saying.
You won't be in Why Not Get Married 3, I'll tell you that.
Brandon.
Brandon T.
The fact
I said it.
You feel like
it.
You've been set up. You feel like you've been set up a little bit because the light movies open up to 3,000 theaters and you don't really have a fighting chance to compete because 1,900
No, I'm not saying we don't have a chance to compete because it's tracking well with African Americans.
But I'm just saying if they open your movie in 3,000 theaters, it is more.
Well, when I did Percy Jackson, I did Tropic Thunder. It was like, yo, you got 90,000 theaters, whatever.
It wasn't because of you. Yeah, it was Tom Cruise.
It's a different. Listen,
Robert Downey Jr.
Let's not even call it a black or white movie.
Let's go.
The budget on those movies.
What's going on?
They get more of those type of theaters. Movies with this budget, which is about what, 15, 20
Vampire
million?
Vampire Suck costs 15 million.
Well, that's hot right now. The whole that shit's going to be over pretty soon. So I won't even compare.
Y'all should throw
vampire
praise.
They're suck the life right out of there.
Piranha 3D is going to
You should have called it lottery ticket.
I should have called it what?
What?
Lottery ticket.
Brandon T. Jackson, do you know how to make s'mores?
What the fuck?
He used to be a Cub Scout counselor.
Who is this? No.
You're reminding him of young Boy Scouts
future
right now.
Future makeup artist
take
right here.
Take another compliment.
Son got the same outfit.
Same size.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Hold on. Look at it.
Sorry.
So talk about your other movies you've done. You've done a gang of movies. You know what I'm saying?
We got Big Mama's House 3 coming out. All that coming out.
Is Martin in that?
Yes, Martin is in that.
So it might do well.
It might do well.
I'm just kidding.
We pumping a lot of... Why?
I'm just messing with you. I want you to get your own starring vehicle.
I'm about to, but let me at least...
Louis Dick will be starting House Party 7, so...
I'm just messing with you, man. No, nobody messing with
you. But you can't...
Hey, man, I'm just... I noticed when you came in...
It's not funny.
This is what I'm noticing, Brandon. I've watched you grow a little bit. Like, every time you come
not
in,
really.
your pants are sagging a little more.
No, it's not.
Now you got a little entourage. Another dude here with hair like yours.
That's where you're wrong. I bet if you need some lotion, he's holding it for you. See, your perception of young people these days is wrong, dude. First of all, I don't sag my pants much.
Oh, you are sagging.
I don't sag my pants. That's
why are you looking, Louis?
Well, because
because I'm a parent, and when I see young
people, you ain't his parent,
nigga. I'm 25. How old are you?
Dressing like you 16.
Steve Harvey, how old are you? Stop. Stop talking to me like this. I'm tired.
I'm still funny.
Get his veneers off the mic, nigga. His veneers.
877-2-106-106.
He said, get
his veneers off the mic.
I'm just saying.
I can't stand
I'm not saying
this.
Anything
nigga,
wrong.
Nigga,
listen.
Damn, nigga, the old
But you know what? If you kids, if you
son,
young people are going to go
son,
out here and wear what you want and all that, then be open. No, you can't have us not criticize. That's our right.
Can I say something on that?
You are sagging.
Nobody sags. That's so 80s.
Stand up and look at you. You are sagging. Oh, don't pull him up now. You came in with your behind. Don't even try.
You saw your
ass. As my grandmother would say, I saw your name, address, and phone number.
Thank you, Kevin Hart. Oh, please get this. Hey, it's about to be a fight.
Yeah, now. Here comes somebody else your height. Now he can get into it.
Battle of the B movie.
See, I told you.
Kevin Hart is in the building.
Yes, I am. My movies have grossed over 200-something million.
Hold on.
They got Brandon on the road.
Hold on.
Just put a cigarette
ladies
out.
And gentlemen, into the house, we got my great friend, Mr. Kevin Hart.
What's going on, y'all?
We had a good time in Philly, man.
Hey, oh, see, look at him. Already jumping on the joint. Get off his joint.
Lil Dix, you are a hater.
We had a great time.
Lil Dix, you are a hater.
First and foremost, let's all acknowledge where I'm sitting. This is where Jamie Foxx normally sits.
Yeah, we put a booster chair in there for you.
So now it's called a heart hole.
Yeah, good one. Two back-to-back bombs.
Kevin Hart, we said.
Listen, the reason why I'm sitting here is because he's not here, so today I feel like taking over.
Right. Hey, you know what, Kevin Hart? You can do that.
Yeah, well, I can.
If you can measure up to the sign, you can take over.
Welcome to Heart Hole Radio.
Big shoes to fill.
Look, hey.
What?
Buddy.
No,
look, right now, let's shut it down. Okay, I want to catch up.
Oh,
I want to know what's going on.
I thought we were friends.
We about to let
you have
to Lil Dix thinks he's funny.
He said
funny.
Lil Dix.
No,
he said Lil Dix.
Lil Dix.
They're battling right now.
He's mad because he thinks young people sag their pants still. He thinks it's 1999 crisscross. You're wrong, dude.
Hilarious.
He sucks. I'm done.
Brandon, you see, I already know what Brandon's doing wrong. Johnny, go ahead. Finish filling me in.
I'm just going to fill you in right now. What we were talking about was we filling you in on Brandon T. Jackson and this movie coming out, Lottery Ticket, and his acting career as well as his stand-up career. So Brandon T. Jackson was telling about, you know, he got a movie coming out, Lottery Ticket. I keep saying it on once so people go see it. And he's only on 1,900 theaters. Is it 1,900?
Yeah, 1,973. And it's tracking well with African-Americans.
Okay, keep going. And tell him, fill in, because you guys do the same genre of film, so you guys can go back and forth.
What does that mean?
I don't. Movies is movies.
Yeah,
I don't look at a black movie or white movie. It's movies.
Yeah, Speedy. Movies are movies.
That's what I'm saying.
Not the ones that you do. We're talking about the other ones, Speedy. Now, Brandon.
Yeah, those are called videotapes. The ones Speedy.
Lottery Ticket comes out today, by the way.
Today, August 20th. Yeah, today.
Go see Lottery Ticket.
First and foremost,
congratulations,
Brandon.
What do you mean, Brandon T. Jackson, you say it's tracking well? What does that mean?
Well, he's being sarcastic.
No. When you say it's tracking, I'm reading Variety. You say it's tracking well.
Right.
In other words.
With us.
With us. Then when I go to the theaters, I see white kids, I see black kids, I see Chinese kids. Hip hop done crossed over everything, but what they try to keep doing is going, putting us off to the side and going, okay, these guys are over here. They're in the hood.
But saying it's just a black movie.
Exactly.
Just black people are in
exactly. And that's
it.
What, now when I,
So I have a question.
What's
so
up,
when you do a movie and it's an all black cast, what do you call that?
No matter, black
tracking
is just,
well with black people.
But listen,
nigga shit.
No, it's not true. It's not true. Though.
Dr. Laura is what I call it.
Well, let's ask Kevin Hart. True. You did Soul Plane. How did that?
Oh, Soul Plane is a black movie. I mean, you can try to avoid it all you want, but it is what it is. It's
my
a black
thing
movie.
Is black people across.
Did it track well black with black people?
My movie hell tracked no. well with niggas without money to go to the theaters. Anybody that was stealing shit saw Soul Plane at the time.
It was number one in the barbershop, yeah, I'll tell
movie,
you that.
My movie came across during the time when it was looting. So it's a different time. No, but you know, you gotta look, support is support. I don't yes. give a shit if it's black, white, whatever. They
you can
call
meet
it whatever
Dave
you want.
Or
I think you have to listen, Brandon, what he's trying to say. He's saying he did this movie, which is seen by, was going to hopefully be seen, and usually
everybody.
Movies have been seen by everybody, but they like to pigeonhole it and only put it in so yeah. many theaters. It, like I said, like it said every Magic Johnson theater.
Right.
But not, and not, in one, not in one Larry Bird theater.
But that is the way the system is built.
And he's saying it's wrong.
Saying
well,
it's wrong.
But well, what I'm saying is if you're going to say
remember
the system.
Remember when you did Cornbread Earl and Me?
And you played Cornbread.
No, yes. Actually,
you played Mustache Earl.
Remember when you did These Ain't My Sandals with Tyler Perry? Remember when you did that new play? These Ain't My Sandals.
What I'm trying to, what I'm trying more, to explain to Brandon is
oh,
that.
Oh, these ain't my
these are not my split toes.
Fight him off, Lewis.
Well,
fight him off.
What I'm trying to explain to Brandon is that I understand you come in here and you're having this voice, but what I'm finding out with you young people is that you're not informed
some
enough.
People stuff.
Well, because you're not
I read,
informed
I
enough.
Read.
Well, you're only
I'm
reading
a nerd,
the surface,
dude.
But what I'm telling you this, Brandon, is that that's the system. And if you're going to fight the system, you have to have the ammunition to do so. Now, keep in mind, your movie is not being advertised on Fox News. It's not being advertised in other venues
but
where
MTV,
white people sit.
MTV.
Okay, but what I'm saying is hip-hop has crossed over, but it has not crossed over all the way into where you want it to be, to where your lone voice can come out. You have to create more.
Well, I want
to
correct you on that.
I'm done with the separation.
Yesterday,
if Will Smith can do it, we can do it.
I was watching the football game yesterday, and they ran a trailer about your movie. I was watching the NFL channel, and they advertised your movie. So they put man advertising all trailers on all networks.
But it's tracking.
What's the name of that play
again?
What's the name of that play?
Which one? These Ain't My Sandals.
Kevin Hart, let's talk about you and your career. What's going
What's up,
on?
Kevin? Hey, the hottest stand-up. Hey, too much, man.
Oh, my God.
Here's what you can't get caught up in, though, Brandon. Brandon's turning into, like, Janine Garofalo.
Thank
like, you.
You
know these comedians that go and they start doing things, they want to make a change. You can't get caught up in that world, dude. It is what it is.
I forget it now.
Reality is reality. I'm telling you some real shit.
I'm going to stop.
No matter what, look, no matter what, your movie is.
I gave up, man.
It is what it is. But it's your job. If you're looking for your movie to cross over, you have a fan base. You reach out to your fan base, and you explain what you feel it is to them.
Can we get out of the hood, though? Do we have to have every movie in the hood?
But why would you want to get out the hood?
Well, listen, that's a hood movie.
Hood is good money.
That's a hood movie.
No, I'm saying not get out of black, but can we just, like, have a different setting?
Yeah, but why?
Like, but listen, time out. No, we got to figure out what we're talking about. That movie right
the
there,
Jeffersons.
That movie's a hood movie. Agree?
Yeah.
Lottery ticket?
It's about a kid who wins.
All right, now let's talk about Percy Jackson 2.
Okay. That's not a hood movie.
Not a hood
it's
movie.
A mainstream movie.
And
mainstream.
Even Big Mama's House is a movie that's going
it's
to...
A mainstream movie.
It's a mainstream movie. So it's not about the black cast. It depends on...
Tropical Thunder.
And you have more than two black people.
So you do them all. So you should even make up... This money right here, this movie right here, as opposed to Tropic Thunder... will make you more money on the road
than anything else.
Than Tropic Thunder.
In the black club.
Yeah, because they aren't seen it. No black people don't see it to like DVD or whatever.
Didn't see what?
Tropic Thunder?
I did. I went to the movie theater and saw it.
Twice. Oh, you did.
I saw it twice.
I'm just saying. So,
No, because I went and saw because you're a friend of mine. I've seen all your movies in the theater. It's going to sound like chicken shit. I saw Soul Plane in the theater.
Hey, I saw Soul Plane in the theater.
I saw Don't Drink Your Gin and Juice. That was your movie you was in Christmas.
I saw
that in the theater.
I saw These Ain't My Sandals in the theater, too.
This is crazy. Right?
The projector was off. They were just looking in front of the curtain.
All right. That's pretty funny there.
He started the movie with Steamboat Willie.
He hates me now. Lou Dix hates
me. No, I think you're very talented.
So you understand? So don't
I'm
discredit.
Kevin Hart. I'm done.
Don't discredit these movies.
It's
that,
a good
that,
thing, man.
You know what I mean?
I'm not discredit. I'm telling them not to discredit because white folks, white kids like us too. That's all I'm saying.
They're coming.
When people hear it's tracking well with black people, white people that may have been thinking about CMA and say, "Oh, it's a black movie. I'm not going to go." May turn them off. Is that what you mean?
Yes.
Okay, I get it.
That's why I
my white side gets it.
Yeah, we're going to take a quick break right now. Come back.
We're going to take a short break?
A short break with Brandon T. Jackson and Kevin Hart.
You know, when I come back, Speedy's on.
Kevin Hart, you got to change. Like, you got darker.
Hey, man, well, you know how
to do. You just ran out of Ambi. We're going to take a quick break and come right back.
Twitter me at Brandon.
You're going to take a quick break and come right back. Yo, we're back here at the Foxhole. We're back here at the Foxhole. We got some great guests, man. Brandon T. Jackson holding it down.
My mustaches.
And we got my man, Kevin Hart. We're going to go to Lou Dix right now to talk about his new experience.
Hey, listen, as you know, I'm Louis Dix, and the Foxhole used to be my family until they kept talking about me. But listen.
Just like your wife.
That's cool. Look, I rode around in my new luxury home on wheels, which is the BMW 5 Series. That's right, Gran Turismo. It's a nice little car. It fits me. It's like a lounge. I used to hang out with Speedy, TDP. And yeah, we used to watch the game.
Oh, okay,
yeah, and we go to our softball games. I would invite Kevin Hart and Brandon T, but there's no room in the car.
You got trunk space.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, Kevin, you can fit in the glove compartment. But no, I'm serious. Only because the BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo has a great glove compartment, so you too can sit Kevin Hart in your BMW, and he can ride around with you. Thank you, BMW North of America. We love you.
OG Portis.
Thanks for the Bud Lights. They finally brought us some in. Bud Light with superior drinkability, that just right taste. Not too heavy, not too light.
I'm drunk right now.
The unique ability to elevate good times with friends like Bokeem and Chris everyone here. Bud Light's drinkability, that just right taste, not too heavy, not too light, is what sets Bud Light apart from other light beers. It's the sure sign of a good time, that just right taste, Bud Light.
And when you and Kevin Hart, you just take short sips.
That's good. That's good. That's good. Now I can definitely tell why you made it.
I love Bud Light.
Bud Light is always a sure time, sure sign of a good time.
She's drunk.
And here we go.
She's drunk.
Yeah, she is.
Goes
good. She's probably high.
We got some great guests, but I got a great friend of mine.
I doubt
You know, great actor. I can't even front on him. I loved him in Strapped. I loved him. My favorite movie, Life, when you played Can't Get Right.
Yeah, yeah.
You should have
got a spinoff on that.
That's a great acting, yes.
Jason Leary's when he went crazy at the end. You know, and I loved you in Ray. You know, you played Fathead in Ray. You played Fathead in Ray. Give it up, ladies and gentlemen, my man, 10 grand, Bokeem.
Good looking out, Bokeem. So yes, happy to be here.
We got three working guests.
That's what's up. I ain't as funny as the rest of y'all, but
that's a nice
I'm
Negro
very happy
name
to
right
be
there.
Here.
That's a great Negro name.
Bokeem. We're going to get right into it. You got a new movie coming out. I don't like the name of the motherfucker. It scares me. But let's talk about your new film you got coming out called
Devil.
Now let's talk about that.
Okay. Why'd you say with extra?
Are you the devil?
Are you the devil?
The devil.
You know what? It's a Universal Pictures release, so I had to sign a non-disclosure, and it's been a minute since I've been in a studio pic, so I'm not trying to burn any bridges. I am not at liberty to say
what the movie is about.
So you played the devil's advocate.
Go see my movie.
Is it White Devil?
Well, talk a little bit about the movie. Tell us about the movie.
Basically, this is what I can't say. It's a supernatural thriller that involves five people who, under normal circumstances, would never interact, and they get thrust into the situation where one of them is not who they appear to be.
The devil.
Well, we could have figured that out, man.
Let's just throw it out real quick in a minute. That Bokeem isn't the best at describing what something's about. let's just kind of leave those questions out of there. We don't really want to
prove it. Kevin Hart, would you like to describe what the movie is?
No, I mean, based off what he just said, I mean,
be short about it, though.
Basically, the movie's about a devil.
Okay.
That's all I got.
Kevin Hart, where was it filmed and how was it filmed?
Well, because of his disclosure, he basically said what the studio did was film a movie about a devil. And
are you in the film?
Yeah, we don't really know if he's in it.
No, right now.
I don't know. Is it? Yeah, because
where did they shoot this movie at?
Where did
you shot it?
In Hell Kitchen?
Nah, Toronto.
Oh man,
Toronto, Canada.
Yeah.
Speedy, you were out there filming. Wait, sorry. No, that's a low blow. Speedy,
Bokeem,
I'm
when
sorry.
Is this movie supposed to come out?
It'll be out.
Sorry,
you know I got a real short temper with you right now.
It's all good. The film comes out September 17th.
Are you doing seance too?
Are those my sandals?
Yeah, this is when I wish I would have learned more about comedy.
Okay. Bokeem.
Speedy's thinking the same
for
thing.
Role, dramatic dudes. Yes.
For a role like this, Bokeem, to prepare for the role that you played, would you have to be discreet about? What did you do to get your devil, quote unquote, practices up?
Was you in the mirror going, oh.
Hold on.
No, that's my regular practice before I, you know, step out into the world.
Why didn't you go out for this, Speedy? What were you doing?
I went to see a shrink,
actually.
He was
eating devil's egg.
Whoa, shit. Are you serious?
Yeah, I went to see a psychotherapist.
Serious moment, you guys. Yeah.
You went to go see a shrink.
It was my character has some
issues. Don't say it.
No.
Believe me, I practiced this all morning. I'm good to go. I know exactly what I can say. I'm right here in the box. I'm all good.
Okay, I want to have you in Soul Plane 2.
Or maybe you want to go meet Dave. I'm just saying.
And find some fool's gold. Hey, or you could go to Speedy's movie.
We don't have one. Speedy, you got to give me one. Just give me one, Speedy, before you die. Speedy's IDMB. Speedy's IDMB came up BMW dealership.
He
plays the bailiff and all the.
Speedy, you've done nothing.
I've done something.
You've done nothing.
I've done
you
something.
You had 30 years in Hollywood and nothing.
Hey, we got to promote Satan's Kitchen. Come on.
What are we doing, dog? What are we doing?
All right. Yeah. No, I had to go ahead and reach out to a shrink because all of the characters in the movie have their own little quirks, and I wanted to take mine to the next level. And I was like, well, I don't have this quirk in my personal life. So
what's the name of your character?
What was your name, character?
I can't even really go into that.
Hey, I have
Billy
a
Beelzebub.
You have some other movies coming out as well. Can you talk about those?
Absolutely. I got a couple of other pictures coming out. One's called Little Murder.
Hey, Kevin Hart.
Well, Kevin Hart played the serial killer.
No, Speedy, that was Little Mermaid.
I thought it was Little Seymour. My bad.
Go ahead. So you got
Little Murder, starring Josh Lucas and Terrence Howard.
Terrence Howard.
What did he play? Did he on the soundtrack?
What's Terrence Howard? Before or after the
More Money?
The movie situation that he didn't get the more money. What's
the
was it before or after
really
Iron Man?
I'm not really at liberty to discuss the brothers' business practices.
You sign a goddamn disclosure letter with that nigga.
So, Terrence, you say I can't say nothing. All right.
877-2-106-106.
It's a really good project. It takes place right after Katrina. And basically, I play a cop trying to find a serial killer. Josh Lucas is a cop, too, but we're at odds with each other.
Same
Terrence Howard is a suspect, but him and Josh become tight. So, you
same,
know,
same man.
It's very interesting.
When's your movie Devil come out? September what?
September 17th.
Josh Lucas did Stealth, right? That's
there
the guy
you
that did
go.
Stealth.
Exactly.
Yeah,
exactly.
That's the one to put the black guy on Jamie Foxx's career right there.
good luck with that movie. Good luck.
Go ahead, Lou Dick.
Yeah, Bokeem, welcome. I have a question. Congratulations on you and your wife having your child.
Oh,
now,
thank
is
you.
Is this your first one?
Yeah, now he's an uncle.
Absolutely. she's not here yet, but in January we're going to have our first little girl.
That's beautiful, man.
And I'll be really looking forward to it.
And how long have you been married?
3 years. 3 years and a couple weeks.
Is this your first marriage?
It's my first and last.
And how about her? It's her first?
Yeah, absolutely.
Good, then you got purity, so keep it up. All right?
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
What are you talking about, Lewis?
You know what I'm talking about. Neither one of them have been married. That means they're on a good track to begin things
Lewis.
Right. No baggage is coming
kill
into
yourself.
Their
what are you that's talking
this
about?
My divorce.
Is this your that's purity.
Shut the fuck up.
That's purity. That's
Kevin
purity.
Hart.
That's great.
Now, you were married.
That's
are you
great.
Married?
Hey, look, man.
Yeah, you went through some stuff, so back it up. You know what I'm talking about. There's no purity going on.
You signed a disclosure letter for that.
I signed a disclosure letter.
You still married, right? Yeah, you still married.
I signed a disclosure letter to Bokeem before we got here not to talk about certain things. And we're both honor and I couldn't.
You are married,
because the devil is getting in between y'all relationships.
Listen. Let me go ahead, Kevin Hart.
Oh,
see,
no,
that was clever. Y'all missed it.
I heard you guys got to a little altercation.
So, Brandon T. Jackson, when is your movie come out?
August 20th, but I'm not going nowhere. I'm going to chill with y'all. We got Bud Light. Today, whatever. What's it? Today.
Yes.
Go see Lottery Ticket. Me and Chow Down. I mean, Bow Wow.
Chow Down.
Me and Bow Wow, we having a good time, yo. In the movie. It's a good movie, man. I'm getting tweets
well
right now.
With black
did
people.
You guys get along, you
and
Bow Wow?
Yeah. Bow Wow's cool. Bow Wow's actually cool. He's cool.
Why your voice go up?
Yeah, did he try to punk you?
Because
playing now.
He tried to hit you with his platinum albums?
No, no, no. Bow is a cool young brother. Like, y'all,
I met him before. He's nice.
He's cool.
Y'all did two movies together, though. Didn't he, bro? I mean, he's cool. Like, I don't have nothing bad to say about him. Like, for real. He tweets a lot on why he acting, but besides that, he's cool.
Wow.
Let me ask you, but did
sound
you guys,
like somebody I know.
Did you guys both audition for the same role and he got
no.
it?
Oh.
Damn, Lewis.
I decided to take a humble a role.
No,
and
you didn't decide
it.
This is Hollywood. You don't decide anything. They decided for you.
No, Lewis, you are right about that. Except for Speedy's case. Speedy does not. He does not want to be where he is.
No, no, no.
In life
I want
right
to listen. I want to be. Listen. Let's think about it. I want to be the comic relief. Think about it. Bow Wow has more name recognition. Why try to sell a movie? I can't sell a movie.
Hold
yet.
On. Let me get your shovel so you can keep cleaning this up. Go ahead.
Jesus Christ. Bro. It's a hostile environment today.
Man. Yeah. Yo.
Why are you so?
You know what? You know what, Brandon?
Can't
T. Jackson,
compare our careers.
Any movie that you're doing is a fantastic movie. I'm gonna support
Thank
it 100.
You. Yeah, man.
It's just hard for us
Ludix,
to get in the movie.
You
can tell by the rest of the niggas that ain't in movies. It's really, really hard to get in the movie. Now let's go back to Bokeem who.
Bokeem who has the devil coming out.
Can I say
out.
You are really a good actor?
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Johnny Mac. And I got that check for you for saying
Thank
all
you so
nice
much.
Things.
Thank you so
much.
I take it in Bo like Keem. Bottle cap. Like some of the movies you've been in, you've always been a very, like I loved you in Ray. You did a great part in Ray.
Thanks, man.
And what was your first movie?
The first picture was Strap.
Strap. And what was that about?
This young brother who was trying to get his girlfriend who's pregnant out of jail. And the only way he can do that and come up with the funds is, like, to cut a deal with the cops and involves him, like, you know, basically infiltrating a gun-running situation and
right.
turning against his friends. And so he's caught in this, you know, situation where he might have to turn in a friend, but
right.
he wants to get his girl out and blah, blah,
that
blah.
That came out August 20th, right?
Nah.
That was the shit, though.
You know,
that was a good movie. That was a good movie.
I'm going to tell you, when you was, like, one of the most powerful is that a word, powerfulness? I don't know.
No. I like it.
When no. you was in Dead Presidents, nigga.
Oh, my God.
Dead Presidents is good.
And
when
That's
you,
what
you
is.
Was in Dead Presidents, when I say when you cut the dude's head off and put it in your duffel bag,
yeah.
Wow. It smelled like Louis' mustache the whole time you was there.
I have a question.
He
didn't say
my mustache.
Bucket.
And they made you bury it like they had to do with her cat.
You know, that was
hey,
that was
I'm saying you buried
my dead cat, Ivan.
They did not bury the cat, Speedy.
What they do?
They made soap out of it.
Somebody going to hell. We talking about dead
and a
cat.
Whole lot
my
of guitar.
Devil coming out.
My cat just died. He's making fun of my loss.
Oh, yeah, that's
hey, I have a question for you, Bokeem.
You know what? We're going to go to Porter's. I'm quite sure Porter's going to have something fantastic to say. You know, well, you ask any one of these people a question, Porter's, about their careers and lack of it, whatever you want to say.
Okay, well, I know I was around when Bokeem did Strapped. Actually, my promotions company was hired to promote that movie, and it was your first one. So what are some of the lessons or... What roles would you like to play that you haven't had an opportunity to yet?
You know, it's interesting, but I want to break into comedy a little bit.
Really? No. But that voice?
Yeah.
You know what's funny, though?
Yeah.
Dramatic actors are actually really better in comedies these days. If anybody know the formula, they get a lot of dramatic actors in comedies. It makes it funnier because they don't expect it to come from a dramatic actor.
What's the attraction of being a comedian?
His sunglasses.
Because the timing, comedic timing is a real challenge. I've been in a few comedies. A lot of people probably haven't seen one called Blackmail, one called Almost Heroes,
that
Chris Farley's last picture. So
you paid the dope deal in that movie?
No.
Put Bokeem in comedy, but he's still the bad guy.
Yeah.
They Jedi mind trick. No, this is gonna be funny. It's gonna be great. Bokeem, action! Fuck everybody in the building.
You do play crazy a lot. A lot of crazy roles.
Yeah.
Well, I've been in a couple crazy roles. You know what it is? I think I'm more remembered by certain people. It depends because it depends on where I am
did
in the world.
That,
I go to some places and around the world, and people will. Remember some a film to me that's obscure or that I wouldn't think that people would remember, and that's what I'm more known for. So it kind of depends on where I'm at, to tell you the truth.
Can I
you signed that contract yet? Did it come to you yet?
Which one?
The dudes with the hoods on, they get you yet?
No. I got something that, you know, prevents them from
okay,
stepping
because
to me. So it's all good.
The devil, the movie that, no. They got hoods on. Why
go ahead, Porter.
The dudes in the club.
Shit, that's I'm my question.
That's because you high. Okay, get brace yourself,
Bokeem. Oh, I know what it was.
He doesn't know how to make s'mores.
Why do actors hire psychiatrists and psychologists?
In a personal life?
Or I mean, when you're doing that preparing like that. For a role, is it that intense mentally?
For this is the only time I've ever done that. And it, I needed to do it because, I had to go places I hadn't really gone before. So I said, who better to, talk to about that than a professional?
You didn't want
to
get your Heath Ledger on?
You know, knows how to
get into a person's mind. You can't tell us what the movie is about at all? Or can we?
Yeah. Basically, it's a supernatural thriller about, five
winning
people.
Winning a lottery ticket.
Who, under normal circumstances.
And then you get on the soul plane.
This ain't the devil. Coming soon, Lou Dix. Bow wow.
So anyway, it's a supernatural thriller about five people who, under normal circumstances, would never interact.
Keep painting that, right?
Go through. You have a lot of changes.
Claudia, you got a question? You want to ask any one of our celebrities?
No.
you don't want to know the 40 time or nothing like that?
I'm over that.
Okay.
No, he's got a
Lou Dix
for a long time.
Thank you.
I will actually.
How many cats you got, Louis?
Listen, Bokeem, I wanted to ask you, do you have any athletic background? Did you play
what
sports or
fuck?
Well, I mean Kevin, listen.
I'm not talking to you.
Do you like gladiator movies?
You like Code 45?
No.
Scraps is a boy dog.
Yo, crazy.
Yo, what's your favorite color, dog?
Nah.
Color blue dog.
How do you feel about anal?
Well, I'm asking because some of his films have been very physical, and he's physical cat. And I just don't know if he played football, basketball.
I never played football. I trained kung fu.
Hey, how do you feel about dunking?
Dunking?
Do you dunk the basketball? Like, what are you talking about?
I can't hoop. I can't hoop at all.
It's a grown man's question.
Here's why Lewis's questions are bad.
It's a mustache question.
This is why his questions are bad. This is why his questions are fucking horrible. Johnny, I'm going to ask you a question.
Okay.
Answer my question. I'm going to show you Lewis.
Okay.
So, Johnny.
Yeah.
Okay. Up top, you're in shape.
Yeah.
Safe to say.
He said up top.
Safe to say. Safe to say you go to the gym.
Right.
What do you do at the gym? What do you do?
I go down to the gym. I mostly box. I don't really get into the aerobics and shit. I just box.
Okay.
He didn't have a follow-up.
This nigga has no follow-up. He asked the question fades away after they answer. He has no fucking rebuttal.
Do you need the mustache or the...
Kevin Hart, what do you got coming? I know you got mad movies.
Tons of stuff, dude.
Tell me about what you got coming up.
Little Fockers, you guys can see that Christmas time.
What's it called again?
Are you the nanny in that?
I got the nurse. I play Ben Stiller's nurse.
Yes.
What's the name of the movie?
Little Fockers.
That's going to be good.
And you play Little?
No.
Now, I have a serious question for you, Kevin.
I'm not going to put the banana in the tailpipe.
No, it's
go
a serious question.
Go ahead, listen.
And a lot of people want to know because we think you're very talented. You're stand-up talented.
Here we go.
Have you been taking acting lessons?
I do. I take personal classes on my own time.
I think Kevin's a good actor.
Shut up, boy.
Listen.
Sorry, Dad.
I know.
Oh, my God. Dad's mad at me now.
Sorry, Dad.
No, he
would be your dad's dad.
The real dad came out. Shut up, boy. God damn it. Sit down.
Yeah, but it'd be like, go to my room.
Lou, how old are you, dog? How old are you?
I'm 47 years old.
How old are you, dog?
I'm 47.
There's a one in there somewhere.
Kevin Hart.
Kevin,
finish answering this.
What else? Yeah. Movie called 35 and Ticking. Movie called Let Go.
I mean, who's in this movie? Will you name
them? TV show. 35 and Ticking is me, Megan Good, Nicole Larry Parker, Mike Epps.
A black movie.
This one is. I'll say it.
Yeah.
I don't give a shit. These black movies sell out 5,000 seaters for me on the road.
Hey. So they walk and call with African Americans.
I'm going to be in them theaters all my life.
I ain't mad at you.
Kevin.
Niggas love support. I love them too.
Have you ever filmed any celebrity women?
What?
I just wanted to know that.
What are you talking about?
Have you filmed any female celebrities?
Don't ask me that
have
question.
Have you been, Brandon, have you been with any celebrity
Claudia,
women?
Stop calling my house.
Stop
at 3
it. Come on.
No,
you don't have a house.
She said
But I do. 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 But I do.
Bokeem, celebrity relationships that we don't know
do
of?
Do an adult film personality?
Yeah,
film,
sure.
I
no.
do.
Kevin Hart, back to you again.
So no, I don't mess with that world.
Kevin Hart, who's stronger, you or your wife?
What?
Wait, Claudia, why do you get so mad when people hit on you? Let me ask you that. You're a beautiful woman.
No, don't get mad at me.
Okay, you're hot.
Huh? Thank you.
I'm a young dude looking at you like you're hot.
Claudia's hot for a woman with old hands. Claudia's hands.
I'm a hand model. What are you talking about?
Claudia has
the strongest hands.
Kevin, don't be intimidated because my hands are bigger than yours.
No, they are. They are. Claudia has the hands.
They were old hands.
Okay, Kevin Hart. Tell us about
dare.
I had a crush on you.
Sophia Loren hand.
You did? I had a she has nice cat crush hand. On Claudia.
I didn't know you had a crush on me.
Brandon, yes.
She's didn't. Too old for you, Brandon.
Is she?
Like, she has abortions the same age.
I've said that often, actually.
Ludwig.
Kevin Hart.
Wow. That's
tell
hysterical.
Tell us about, you have a DVD that's out right now that's selling?
Seriously, Funny is out. People, that's my last hour special. If you haven't seen it, go get it. It's currently platinum. Yeah, that's right. First 2 weeks. I did it. Dropped those numbers.
Good for you, Kevin.
Yeah, no, thank you.
Ludwig, what's your numbers? These ain't my these
no,
ain't
Speedy,
my numbers.
Speedy, actually, I saw Speedy selling the DVD at the comedy show we were at. No, it was just... The funny thing is, listen, I swear to God, the same number that were on the table before the show was the same exact number afterwards. And I think one lady brought the label that said Speedy. Like, nobody brought the DVD. But why are you selling the DVD, Speedy? From what?
Something
like,
totally different, dude.
From what, though? But what did you, like, what did you tape?
No, it was from a totally different show.
Oh, at least.
Look, how, you know look at your attitude just now.
I'm being real.
Fuck
cool.
You're real.
You know what? You young. You know what, Speedy? I'm with you on that. You little young upstarts. Y'all got a little rhythm going now.
Your
y'all
mustache and I were back at a different place.
Yes.
First of all, what's an upstart? That's the first thing.
What is upstart?
What is an
upstart? You know, I mean,
you up and coming.
Yeah. I mean, look, Kevin. I mean, it's been labeled and it's been Kevin Hart will be the next Eddie
Cat
Murphy.
Williams.
Rich Brian. No, I mean, no, really. I mean, they say, I mean, and if you've watched Kevin Hart, you see his gift. I mean, you've seen it from
day
one. No, honestly.
I appreciate it.
You're quick. I mean, anybody that can make the word pineapple funny is funny.
Thank you.
You were funny up in South
Carolina. I mean, you were just, but they're able to create new material the way you do to stay within yourself is a gift. So we know, and I think you handle, no, I really do think you handle it the right way because you always speak to people. Now, Brandon, who just started, on the other hand, needs to be a little humble. I'm just kidding. I like Brandon too.
I didn't just start.
Brandon got a nice, little
I got a little resume. I put my
nice
work
little
in
resume. Like, tell about all the films and
no, it's not just about films. I've been doing stand up since I was 14, dog.
I know. I'm just messing with you.
Hold up, hold up. I'm done being nice now.
Hold on.
I'm done being nice, Lil Dicks.
Brandon might be on roids.
Listen,
I'm just trying to figure
out.
Yeah, Brandon gets mad fast. I'm trying. Here's the only time, Brandon. I only got one time where I was like, "Oh shit, me and Chris, right? We actually were together." Me and Chris Spencer, right?
Like,
this is when Brandon first up. Matter of fact, this is right at the Tropical Thunder, right? Tropical Thunder. I was like, "Yo, man," I said, "Brandon was funny." Like, me and Chris are talking. Swear to God, it's a true story.
Right.
We had a club, right?
Right.
So I'm like, "Chris, Brandon's fucking funny in this movie." I said, "Dude," I said, "he keep a straight head on. Brandon gonna be all right." On cue, Brandon walked in with a leather jacket with like 9 zippers on it, right?
I seen it.
And he had a cigarette in his hand. I said, "Brandon, what's up?"
It was a fake cigarette. I was going for a roll.
This is what I knew. He lost his mind.
I had to see a psychiatrist. Brandon, like the Brandon. Devil over here. I was going for this roll. 1950s roll. It was a fake cigarette.
Brandon put the cigarette out on his palm. That's how I knew. I said, "What's up, Brandon?" I said, "God damn."
That's funny.
877-2-106-106.
Don't we got callers, though? Don't we got callers?
Hold on,
we're
Brandon.
Come back to that.
I didn't go down the lottery ticket and interrupt your shit.
August 20th.
You should have.
Kevin Hart putting cigarettes out on his palms.
We're going to take a quick break and come right back with Brandon T. Jackson, Kevin Hart,
yes,
and Bokeem Woodbine, the Foxhole, Series 106, XM149. Yo, it's the Foxhole, baby.
Oh,
yeah.
Hot
and him a real live African American celebrity who I love, Bokeem Woodbine, Kevin Hart, and Brandon T. Jackson. Twitter him up. How can he reach on your Twitter?
At Brandon T. Jackson.
And Kevin
lottery ticket.
That's how we do it.
Kevin, you're pretty present on Twitter as well.
Yes, I am. We're almost at 500,000 followers.
Damn, Kevin. I need to get on the road.
The name is Kevin Hart, the number 4 real. Talk to me. You know, be a part of my life.
Hysterical. Bokeem Woodbine. You Twitter anything?
You know what? I'm just getting hip to email, man.
Yeah, I don't think the devil Twitter. I don't think the devil Twitter. The devil come right to you.
I'm a little behind the times. I'm a little behind the times.
Niggas in the pier. We're going to go to Lou Dix right now.
Hey, you can Twitter me at mustache.com.
You should start a Twitter page for that.
Hey, I should.
He accepted.
Go ahead, Lou Dix.
Hey, listen, as you guys know, the Foxhole crew has to always be in the know about everything, and that was proved when I, Louis Dix, was sent down to Hattiesburg, Mississippi by the Foxhole management to talk with that football player about playing football for the Minnesota Vikings. So I got in my BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo and got to his home around, I guess, 7 in the evening. We ate, talked a little bit. He said no until I put him in my BMW 5 Series Gran Turismo, and he saw how the BMW GT is loaded with crazy technology. And he said, and I quote, "Lou, this ride is science on wheels. Everything I need from internet to night vision, the GT has it covered." So just like we do here at the Foxhole, you Minnesota Viking fans need to thank us for getting that boy back, even though the Eagles are going to win it. I'm out.
No, they're not.
All right, all right. Thank you for that fantastic fabrication right there.
Yeah, I don't
think that guy will let you on his goddamn property.
I'm confused.
John, it's hard to talk to you with your dreadlock draped over your shoulder like that.
Am I cascading?
Is it kind of sexy to you,
Kevin? It looks like Eddie Murphy's braid and coming to me.
That was funny.
That was funny, Kevin.
Earlier on this show, we were talking about Dr. Laura, who made the nigga comments on her show, and now she has decided to resign. I'm not going to say she lost her job, but she decided, to step down off of her show. Do you think that she should quit or be fired because she used the N-word 11 times in 5 minutes? How do you feel about that?
I feel like
we're going to go to Brandon T. Jackson first. His movie is out right now. Your movie's coming out.
You're funnier,
his movie
too.
Is out.
You're funnier than me, so I got to make
man,
sure
stop
I say
stop saying that. Be a man. Get off his jaw,
get off your jaw.
Get him. Somebody cut his mic off, please.
There's a lot of sexual tension.
No, it's just that.
Oh, Kevin Hart, you did. Oh, Kevin Hart, you did.
Hold on for a second.
I'm about to get on Lou Dix.
No,
I'm a lion, son.
No, you ain't no lion. You're a little cub.
What's this little turkey meat you got under your... No, dude. Stop.
Hold on.
Stop, dude.
Hold on. Somebody got to get up.
Now, somebody.
Somebody. Lou Dix, get up. Lou Dix, get up. Lou, get up.
You better take your half-processed hair out of here.
Oh, wow.
At least I got hair, nigga. At least I got hair.
Hold on 1 second. Now, let's stay on the subject. Brandon T. Jackson.
What up?
How do you feel about the Dr. Laura situation?
Are niggas gonna stop saying nigga?
Niggas ain't.
No, then white people gonna start saying nigga.
I decided to stop saying
it. I'm just saying, if black people keep saying it, white people gonna keep saying it. It's real.
So do you want to say it?
Do you feel she should have resigned or lost her job?
Yeah. But are niggas gonna stop saying it? Are we gonna bury the word or not? That's all I'm asking. I'm asking a question. I got nothing funny to say about him.
Nigga, please.
And exactly why white people will keep saying it. Yeah, get Lou Dix.
Kevin Hart, how do you feel about the Dr. Laura situation?
Dr. Laura.
Here's the thing. Okay, you
I can't even talk without the word nigga.
Okay, you're a damn fool.
You got to, Fox.
You're a damn fool if you don't think white people say nigga all the time. Right. All right? So the X shot.
I say
you
hunky.
Hear it.
In the province of my homes, I say hunky all the time.
All the time. Well, how else will you call that?
Hunky.
So Jerry Fox is
in the
house.
We're all racist.
Jimmy Fox is in the house.
Jamie Fox.
I'm in the house.
In the building.
Jamie. In the building.
In the building.
Fox.
Suck some punk.
In the building. It's Fox on radio. What's cracking? In the house we got.
All right, Bokeem Woodbine.
In the house we got.
Chris Spencer.
In the house we got.
C. Murder.
In the house we got.
Brandon T. Jackson.
In the house we got.
It's your boy Speed.
Oh, come on.
Throw up time. Time to throw up.
In the house we got.
TDP.
In the house. Wait a minute. In my house we got special. He did a big giant favor. Go ahead.
Was it giant?
We got Kevin Hart, a.k.a.
Kevin
Chocolate
Hart.
Drop, a.k.a. Small Face, Little Body, a.k.a. My Time Is Coming, a.k.a. Pay-Per-View, because you got to pay to see me now, a.k.a. My Shirt's Little, But My Legs Aren't. I don't know which one I'm going to stick with, so I'm going to get them all out.
And in the house, we got the number one porn star on Twitter only. On Twitter only. Last name Mac, first name Johnny, middle name motherfucking. When you see him out, I said, there goes
Johnny motherfucking Mac.
Hey, Montana.
I'm trying to be special. I want to be.
All the foxholders and all that. You know what? That's what I love about y'all. Y'all ain't changed. Y'all still satanic right now.
Well, yeah.
She went and lost it right
you,
there.
You think she should? You think she should quit?
Yeah. I think it's time to get on out of here.
Wow, she jumped the shark.
I don't know. I mean, it's her decision. I don't care either way. I never listen to her show anyway.
I think she's going to sit down on the side, let it cool down.
Yeah, she should probably let it. I mean, we got in trouble too. We had to marinate a little bit. Sometimes you do your apologies and things like that. I think what's troubling me is that every time someone white gets mad at anybody, we get
blamed. We get Dog the Bounty Hunter said a bunch of nigga shit.
Don Imus.
Don Imus said some nigga shit.
Some nude pictures of Dr. Lilifoy Fox. Go ahead and feast your eyes on that.
Is she with a nigga?
But here's the thing.
Is that really her?
Yeah. Here's the thing. Did she?
This is her for real?
She had an affair with someone back in the day, and he released the pictures.
She looked like she could.
Shouts out to the full beaver.
She looked like she could. She part of the sucker mean team.
If anybody wants to see this, go to Google and type in Dr. Laura News.
Oh, man, hold on a second.
Sucker mean.
Welcome to Spooge class.
Hysterical.
Oh, look at this pose right here. What is that?
Wow. What's the name of that team again?
I don't know.
Sucker mean team. Sucker mean.
Chris Spencer.
No, that's her for real.
I already told you.
Bokeem, how do you feel? That she should have resigned or just?
Yeah. No, she split. You know, right at the right time, which is what, a day after she said all of that.
Right.
What cracked me up though is when she said, "I want to go ahead and explore my options to express my First Amendment right."
Right.
And all I could hear when she was saying that is, "You want to be able to say nigga more often."
Right.
And you can't do it on the air. She wants to find a venue where she can say nigga.
But black people always say
Sarah Palin chimes.
She said to reload.
She on her
said,
Twitter.
Don't.
Retreat.
Reload on those niggas.
Why?
Explode on those niggas.
Well, give them more niggas.
Well, Sarah Palin was over.
You can see Africa from her front yard.
Spotlight joke of the day, Chris Spencer, he still got it.
If you remember,
man, we doing things.
If you remember Sarah Palin when Barack clenched the Democratic nomination, she was overheard at a restaurant saying, "So Sambo beat the bitch."
Wow. I didn't know.
You can
can we do this though?
She said that.
Are we surprised? Listen, are we surprised that a lot of white people are racist? Are we really surprised?
I am. It surprises me every day when they say my movie's striking well in African American whatever. You know,
Fox. He has a problem with his movies coming out today.
They
always
try to separate our movies though.
And he said
the same thing. What they do? White kids like you, white kids like me, white kids like Kevin, white kids hate loose dicks. The thing is this though.
Look at Louis. Louis just gave up.
Well,
I don't have a seat.
I'm gonna
go to Guy Black and have a conference. Me and Guy Black are gonna talk to someone.
What I'm saying is Jamie.
Go ahead,
they always try to act like the white kids don't like us and they separate our movies, separate us away from them and go, African Americans like them. No, everybody likes Jamie Foxx, everybody likes Brandon, everybody likes Kevin. And you know what I'm saying? The thing is this though, it's
just
like,
waved at Louis.
My thing is, it's just, I'm tired of separation because I grew up in the burbs. And when I would say nigga, my white people would think it was cool to say, "Oh my God, yeah, nigga, you're great." You know what I mean? It's always
now
that.
Now I understand.
Yeah. You know what I mean? I understand what it is.
I understand what it is.
I grew up in the burbs. You know what I mean?
Most of us are niggas.
My thing is this, though. I'm from seven.
None of us grew up in the suburbs.
No, but it's both, though. My dad's church was in the hood, so we both would go to the hood.
But did you have stray dogs in your neighborhood? Stray dogs in your neighborhood.
When I was 15, my dad moved me out to the suburbs. My dad was a hardworking black man. So
listen, right there.
Listen.
Did you let this man talk?
Yeah, he got a movie coming out.
Isn't that beautiful?
He's hard. He's from the cul-de-sac. Finish.
You gave me that tag for that joke. I'm using that. I am from the cul-de-sac. But thing is this, though. You cannot separate us. Black people are cool. We are. And white kids know this.
But why do you feel that the separation is that you're tracking well? They say this movie is tracking well with African Americans.
Just African Americans.
And off the chain with niggers.
Hey.
11 of them.
Right.
11 niggers.
We can't get mad when they say nigger. That's all I'm saying.
No, wait. You're wrong. You're wrong.
Okay, how am I wrong?
Yes, I can.
I want
to.
Let me go to your neighborhood and call me a nigger.
First of all, there are certain things, and what's amazing is that. Anytime someone says Jewish or jokes about Jews, it is completely shut down.
Yeah.
You know why? Because Jewish people ain't taking that shit. They can call themselves whatever name they want to call them. But we have to understand that if we want to call ourselves whatever we want to call ourselves, we can. But at the same time, they can't because they're the ones who actually originated the hate.
Bam.
We didn't originate the hate. You got to understand this. If we're really going to talk about it, the discussion of it is this. It's called slave residue. Mm. Like, for 500 years, if you do one thing for 500 years, there's a DNA in this country. Right. And that DNA has yet to be washed out. I mean, think about it. When I was born in the 60s, I mean, there were still black bathrooms and white bathrooms. So right. You got to understand, those people that were born in the 50s still have that DNA.
And the 30s for Lou Dick.
That's it. That's annoying, though, man. But a new generation, we don't like it.
But here's the thing. As a new generation, what you have to do is this. You have to move forward as a new generation, but also understand that the parents mm-hmm. of the kids that you feel are the new generation, mm-hmm. when they go home, so are you still hanging out with your nigger friends?
Friend.
Don't get too close. Now, the Brandon one, he's good because he believes like we believe.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. He's a nice nigger.
But the thing is this. Don't be ashamed of whatever you feel is black, because one thing I know, Flip Wilson said this. Mm. Flip Wilson said, keep your nigger coat handy and fitted. What he meant was that you will be able to go pop. You will be able to have a lot of people like you in mainstream. But at the end of the day, a white girl told me this.
A publicist. Yeah.
We were hanging out. She goes to a country club in New York. Really, really, well-to-do. No Jews or no blacks are allowed. No minorities are allowed in this country club, right? And she's a tennis instructor. She tells me, I'm so upset with my parents. I what? They just don't like minorities. I what? They don't like Mexicans. They don't like Koreans. They don't like. I said, really? Well, what about blacks? Oh, my God, no. No. Wow. I said, why? Well, they talk about your sexual prowess. They talk about how you play sports. I just overhear my father talking with his friend. I said, really? I said, well, what about Barack and Tiger? Well, yeah.
They're different.
They like them. I said, but what do you mean? Well, yeah, they like them. I said, well, she said, they wait for a black person to make a mistake so they can hate him again.
Right. Wow.
So you got to understand that that's the mentality. But here's the thing.
I'm getting
that does not say, listen, that does not say, that does not say that every white person is a racist. But there are some white people out there that don't even know that they're racist because they feel like this is their land. Mm-hmm. This is what they built. Their forefathers gave them. Think about this. If you think about the forefathers that actually enslaved all of us. How do you think they would feel if they were to see that Barack Obama was president? They would say,
niggas.
They would say, you new white generation failed us because we set this up a certain way. There's no way they could have got with
you,
that.
You do know black men are hot right now with white girls, right? I'm just being real though. Like, cause, because of, no, only date black women. Stop. My baby mama's black. Stop.
Your baby mama.
But your wife would be white.
Jesus. My thing is this.
My tires are black.
Who's this guy? Where'd he come from? Who's this guy? What's up, dude?
TDP.
Where'd he come from? Let me see.
We got niggas on the sideline ready to come in.
No, my thing is this, though, Jamie.
You got new mustaches.
Those are all the words of Brandon T. Jackson. No. My baby mama is black, so I date black women. My thing is, I'm tired of. No, my thing is, have y'all been in Atlanta? Have y'all been to ATL lately? ATL?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
I'm trying to give y'all a word from the young people, as Lou Dick say. I'm trying to tell y'all what it is on some just like.
Brandon, pick a topic and stick on it. God damn it.
Hi, Kevin. Hi, Kevin.
Let's talk about Percy Jackson.
Can we do something? Bro, can you let the dude finish?
All I'm saying is, I was at a place where black people, listen, white people, Chinese people, everything, Pakistanis, they were all dancing and having a good time together. And this was in the ATL in the South, right? And it was all hip-hop. That's what it was. So my thing is this. I think we always going backwards, going, we this, we that, which is fine. I get it. Not saying sell out. It's just like, let's keep going. Like, let's move forward. That's my opinion. Because I white kids come up to me all the time. White kids know Jamie Foxx. White kids love them. They can't keep going. Jamie Foxx is great. Tracking well in the African American communities. That's all I'm saying.
I think that's a good thing. No, I think what's happening.
No, it is a good thing.
Can I say I think I know what you're going through. You're going through an artistic thing.
Mm.
You're going through a thing of what we go up against when we say, well, it's tracking well in African American.
Yeah.
And that doesn't taste good to you because of the fact that you want to be world renowned and universal. This is what I can tell you though. The more true to who you are is how much more they will like you.
Mm-hmm.
Here's the question. Is hip hop, is Lil Wayne pop or is Lil Wayne ghetto? Which one is
No, he's pop now.
He's pop.
Yeah.
So that lets you know something. Lil Wayne don't bite his tongue about anything he like. He like to call himself nigga. He talk shit. He talk about whatever he does. And they embrace it because like when Seinfeld was on, he talked about all the Jewish things that he wanted to in his life, and everybody embraced it. It's something about being happy about who you are and what your culture has to give. It's like I'm watching Dead Presidents the other day. To me, that's Oscar shit.
Great right. movie.
I don't care what I don't care what anybody says, but we can't get upset when they say it's this way because it's been that way for 500 years. You look at the steps that we're making, I put what you're saying into it too. Barack Obama is a step forward in getting past racism. There's going to be some people that are going to hold on. Your Dr. Laura's, your Dog the Bounty Hunters, your Glenn Beck's.
They need to get diarrhea
Your Bill O'Reilly's. I mean, these people, you got to understand, they want things to be a certain way. They are the ones trying to take it back a few steps because now they realize, wow, hip-hop and free thinking actually is about to win. And then they'll say to themselves, where do we fit in all this? Because they're used to...
Legalize it.
Yeah, they're used to managing or controlling the whole situation. Right. So you got to understand, for a white person that's racist, it's the pressure cooker right now because people ain't really with that shit. You know what I'm saying?
Kevin Hart?
Here's my thing about it, though. When you talk about the whole thing with stepping forward and, you know, the white versus the black in that world. Me, myself, I know where I came from. I know what got me to where I'm at. Paper Soldiers, Soul Plane. I don't give a fuck what nobody says. Those are two hood movies.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
hood ass movies. I don't have no mainstream audience without my hood beginnings.
Yeah,
so for me to look at anything and to say, yo, man, why they keep putting me in a nigga circle? I personally don't give a fuck because those are the motherfuckers that fuck with me and love me now.
Yeah. No,
and my life is able to be at a certain point.
I'm not saying that.
Listen, Brandon, I get what you're saying. You're saying that, hey, I don't want you to categorize and say we're tracking well in this community.
Say that word again.
I'm saying white kids.
Well.
I'm saying white kids like us too.
But listen, you shouldn't give a fuck how it's tracking because it has nothing to do with your journey. Like, your journey is for you. Like, what people think about your movie, whatever. That's one step in a career that's supposed
to
be long.
We'll let you know tomorrow.
Let me ask you this. What was Eddie Murphy? Was Eddie Murphy a pop star or was he a nigga?
He stayed that.
I mean,
you know what?
Pluto Nash might have dropped him out of it.
The nigga pulled the donkey shit off like a nigga. That was the most incredible.
Yeah.
He changed the way you watch animation.
Right.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, even Cat Williams tried to do it in a Cats and Dogs?
Either you got small or
they killed that cat in that movie. Oh, I'm sorry, Claudia.
I'm in the Salem Asylum now.
Oh, my bad.
Meow.
Let me get focused. I was on stage with a young man who was budding, coming up, big music guy, and he felt that because of the people that came to see him, he had made it. He said it was a majority white crowd and that we had made it. I said, nah. I said, be careful. I said, nah. Look, I said, I understand that, but it ain't nothing like black people. When black people support you, it ain't look like some niggas that love you. When niggas love you, it's amazing. So what happened was he made a mistake. And all them white people that he thought was fans, I fucking hate this
fucking nigga.
Wow. This fucking
nigga.
Turned his back. He made one mistake. And I'm gonna tell you what it was.
Stop talking about Wayne Brady like that.
No. No, but it was so bad that the white people was mad at me for what he did. I get on the plane. There he is. I'll deal with him in a second.
Like, when you get to 28,000 feet, you're going to have to deal with me.
And I was like, what are you talking about? Because I had seen the Kanye thing like on my iPhone. So when I saw it, I was like, oh, that's cool. That's Kanye being Kanye. I didn't put anything else into it because I was like, he always goes up on stage and he fucks with some people.
Right.
So I turned it off. Man, by the time I get to the airport, man, white people looking at me, oh, yeah, there he is. Yeah, he knows him.
Yeah,
they
gold
saw
digger.
Him together. Look at him. Gold
digger.
Fucking gold nigger. Yeah.
What do you think?
So I get on the plane. The lady can't wait till she pull my tray down. What is his problem? How dare he walk up to that pure white angel? The King Kong of it all is what's getting this girl. It chaps my ass up.
What is she again?
Pure white angel, unadulterated.
What do you
think? She drinks mineral water, and he comes up there with his King Kong waves, swatting at planes.
climbing up the fucking building. Why, oh, why would he do that? I thought it was Nancy Grace. Why did he do that?
Nancy Grace.
And I said, babe, I don't even know what the fuck you talking about if you don't bring my motherfucking shrimp toast and my goddamn Hennessy flat
hot rag.
And my hot rag and let me lean this motherfucking chair back and go to sleep, you white bitch.
Hey, so what do you, what does Speedy do to piss white people off? Why don't they support him? No, really. Kevin has a white girlfriend.
But here was the thing. Here's what was funny.
Kevin had a white girlfriend.
The lady was so mad at me, right? And I was like, I said, baby, I get it. What happened? She came up there. She was going to get her award. It was the first time getting her award. Her mother, everybody was there, and it was just this and it was that. And all of a sudden, he came up there, and he just, I said, well, okay, well, do you know the girl? I said, what's her song? Do you know a Taylor Swift song? Well, no, I don't know. What the fuck? They didn't even know the song.
She's white.
I didn't even know her.
But
she was a pure white.
But at the same, it was like, you know, there was that situation where we always say this. We say that there is no racism, right?
Right.
But we all are racist. Right. Because when Floyd Mayweather was fighting the white boy from London, how many black people was actually
Ricky Hatton?
How many white people was actually rooting for Floyd? And how many black people was actually rooting for Ricky Hatton?
They had a song for Ricky Hatton.
That fight looked like Harlem Nights when they were standing up on the black side or the white side.
I'm gonna knock your ass out.
Wait, now, but listen, is that racist or is that being for your race?
No, it's not necessary. It's whatever you want to call it.
Mine was definitely racist.
Yeah, mine's racist.
But here's my thing is, we all root for our own team.
Right. Yeah.
The problem is that when you get treated badly because you are proud, like when people say, yeah, you only voted for Barack because he was black. Mm. It's a black thing. I said, well, why can't I be happy that the dude is black? Do you see what happened to us in this country to see all of us come together like that? That's an amazing thing. Now, you just bring it all the way down to he's just black. We were on this show and I said, I'm voting for Barack Obama because he's black when he's 30 points down. The phone lines lit up with nothing but black people saying, I will not vote for Barack Obama just because he's black.
Right.
You are going to have to show me what he's about. So that lets you know that we just don't jump on the bandwagon. You know, we're the toughest people in the world.
Look at
fucking Wyclef. Yeah. Nigga, they put hits out on, nigga, you run, I'll kill you, nigga. Yeah. For what?
Those other Fugees.
That's Lauryn Hill.
Jamie, the other two Fugees, like, motherfucker.
I think something you said earlier, Jamie, like, as far as the progress being made and people becoming more forward thinking, you know, the newer, younger generation is getting the people, the establishment that do want things the way they were. They are getting, you know, there it is a pressure cooker. You see a lot of them bursting now and messing up on air. And they used to have it under control in controls. And they're losing it now.
Because the reason of it is
Drake
is
uniting the forces. Drake is uniting white
people. I see way too many people here right now that I didn't know last year. Who the fuck are y'all?
Don't Drake always sound he just woke up?
What am I doing?
What are you doing?
Like, what are you doing, Drake? I'm sorry.
But the thing is that you got to understand, those people are now going like, the people like the Sarah Palins, the people like the Glenn Becks and all those people, man, do you actually think they really like other races? Do you actually think they like, man, look at the pressure they putting on Mexicans in Arizona. What happens when they say, okay, yeah, the niggas is getting out of control? I mean, what happens when all that happens?
Really got the Mexicans.
And the thing is that look how
sharp. The Expendables is about them.
Chris Spencer joke, Buff Light joke of the day.
That was dope. That was good.
But the thing is like this. No, you know what the one white correspondent on Fox said? They're going to get that law passed because America is bullshit, basically. They will not stand up for the Mexicans to make sure that nothing is wrong for them. And nobody did. Nobody stood up. Nobody really said, you know, let's not get to, nobody's talking about it now. And these people are going through. It's like, you know, at a certain point, you got to say, hey, not all anybody is one way, but there are some of you that are very influential that are dictating how people think and how people feel. Because I don't blame the people in Arizona. But I blame the old politicians that cater to McCain. The fears and the insecurities of you. If we wanted to, the way we were treated in slavery, if we wanted to, we could get on BET and 24 hours a day talk about how tragic that was and incite every black person in the world to hate white people.
And that's what they do.
So you said we need slavery uncut?
But we don't want that.
Oh my
Fox on radio, what's cracking?
Other than cracking your ass.
TDP's off the chain, Johnny motherfucking Mac Hollins.
We got a phone call from South Carolina. Odell from South Carolina. What's up, Odell?
Yes, sir. I want to say a couple of things. First of all, if you take the last three letters of any word and you dedicate the IST to it, it only simplifies that is what you have dedicated your life to. And the second thing I want to announce is nobody funnier than the motherfucking foxhole. I don't give a damn.
Yeah! Here! Way to go, nigga.
That was smart, nigga.
Drink your motherfucking Moscato and have a motherfucking nap.
Hey, let me tell you, what's his name?
Odell.
In your ass.
Odell, it's Jamie Foxx, Foxhole Fan Extreme. You got 15 seconds to say whatever you want to say on your mind, man.
Everybody that is not inside of the motherfucking foxhole, bitch, you'll never be funny. Wow. So you may as well just stay your ass at home. I mean, it's okay to do your interview. Come on, man. We're going to watch your movies. But remember this shit. Nobody's going to be funnier than the motherfucking foxhole. So take that, ride with it, bitch, and deal with it.
Thunderbird Productions presents Odell. That's right. Foxhole Radio.
Wait, we got another phone call. We got
that nigga cleaned up that shit he said.
Yeah, I didn't get it at first. We got Greg from LA. About. What's up, Greg?
What's
going on, Foxhole? How y'all doing?
Holler at me, man.
What up?
Hey, man, I got a question, man. Something been bothering me since I've been listening earlier. Louis Bix, what the fuck is your problem? I'm just being real now. That's fine, so we can be real on it. Why the fuck did you ask Brandon T. Jackson earlier to be on Nate Moore? What was your analysis behind it?
Louis Bix, you're getting banged on, dog.
Tell him what it
all
is,
right,
dog.
Well,
tell him what
okay,
it is.
Okay, young man. Listen, Greg. I know you're from L.A.
Greg.
I know your panties are in a bunch right now.
Wow.
But listen, I asked him that because I wanted to ask him. Just because the foxhole is the foxhole, the one thing about us is we're who we are.
I got gangsters.
So Fox don't have a problem with me asking
deck.
The questions I ask.
Hey,
you know what? Go
right
suck
now.
Something, punk. Blue Dick's black Spider-Man suit.
Put that in your s'more.
Well, that's certainly one way of dealing with it.
I think Louis Dick's mustache is a toupee.
Hey, Louis Dick's mustache is caught on fire. Y'all see that?
Louis mustache caught on fire.
I just want to make sure everybody understand that in Phoenix, what it is if you're Latino in Phoenix, you could be pulled over for being Latino until you show your paperwork that you belong here. So everybody need to understand that's what it is.
Or you can Twitter me at Brandon T. Jackson.
Speedy, what did you just... What's that?
I'm bringing knowledge.
But Speedy, why did that fact jump out? Like, where did you feel
it? I was trying to get it in earlier and then Johnny...
But Speedy, it's like, Speedy, I try to root for you in life, but you do things like that to make you realize... Like, you're never going to make it with this attitude.
Follow me
I'm
on
serious.
Twitter.
I think we need to be better friends with Speedy. Y'all got to call him on shit like that. Like, it was a fact for no reason.
Kevin,
like,
why you going so hard on Speedy, man?
Hey, don't take the tag off a mattress. You can go to jail. Your points sometimes, Speedy, just aren't relevant. And we gotta acknowledge that, guys.
Hysterical.
It's a positive day. And Speedy, when you bring that stuff in there, you take back what was just said.
It's better than Lou Dick, though.
Come
Lou
on.
Yo, it's Jamie Foxx. Fox on radio. Oh, this is my favorite right here.
My man.
Ice Bird from New York.
She's not me.
What up, Bird?
Yo, man, let me tell you something, man. I don't even know why anybody even talk about this bitch, Dr. Laura, whatever the fuck her name is, man. Yo, there's a lot of pressure out here in white America. I drive trucks. I go in some towns, dog. I'm hungry. I walk into a restaurant. I see Confederate flags and shit flying. I turn my eyes right around. You ain't gonna piss at my food.
That's called wild lemonade.
There's racism out here. And Dr. Lord, the only point that jumped out at me is, y'all niggas should be happy. There is a black president, and look how many motherfuckers go at Barack Obama. Look at all the disrespect that comes to Barack Obama. All the fucked up shit Bush did, people held their mouth. Yo, people step over the line with Barack damn near every fucking day on TV. He is the leader of the free world. We need to respect him. You ain't got to like him, but show him some respect. And I feel bad for him because let Barack stand up to these motherfuckers. You know when a black man shows assertiveness, they turn it, they say he's aggressive.
Where is Barack's team? That's what I want to know.
They working.
I'm gonna tell you what it is. You know what, Iceberg?
They working.
I'm gonna say right now, Iceberg. I'm gonna say this. We've always enjoyed you coming on here and giving us something real funny and zany, but that right there, man, may be the most powerful statement that you've made, and that's amazing, man. We're going to applaud you on that. And
Where's Biden at? Where is
Can I tell you what it is?
Yeah, I want
to. It speaks to the Democratic Party, period. Me being, I call myself an aggressive Democrat.
Well,
if a Republican says something about us, I'm going to say something about them fucked up. Because they come at us like they don't give a shit. And that's the thing about it. They don't give a shit. They'll endorse a puppy. They don't give a shit who it is running. As long as he
not a cat.
Exactly. As long as he's Republican, they don't give a shit. What we have to do, we are like R&B singers.
Right.
That's how Democrats are. It's like, he got his record out. We don't. Oh, he got fringe on his. We don't like the. Look, what I wanted to happen was Barack, Clinton, Biden, Jesse Jackson, even. What's my other man's name with the perm?
Al Sharpton.
Yeah.
I want all of those Democratic people to come together because all of them singularly will sink each other. Even if Barack now was dealing with a thing with the mosque, right?
Mm-hmm.
As a Democrat, you talk to Barack Obama and you roll with him no matter what.
Right.
Because he understands what's really going on. This guy is the first president we've had in a long time that actually understands how America is supposed to work.
Right.
Mm-hmm. The thing is, when America does work, a lot of times we don't like it because it doesn't work in their advantage.
Yeah.
We have to be more assertive. Yeah. When's the last time you seen a Barack Obama T-shirt?
When's the last time you're talking about?
Exactly.
This.
We don't.
Where's Biden though? Where's Biden?
But, Biden can help you and hurt you. Because Biden to get out there and say something, you know.
A lot of flip of the tongue.
But all I can tell you is like this. You got to have more balls because at the end of the day, even with George Bush, and I knew George Bush was fucking up.
Yeah.
But when they threw the shoe at him, I was like, hold on. You can't just throw a shoe at my folks. Man. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's still American. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So it's like, it's not a racist thing. It's an American thing.
Where's Hillary, though? It's very
disappointing to me as a Democrat that it seems like when Barack Obama's poll numbers were through the roof, everybody's on his nuts. Now that he's having some troubles, everybody's abandoning him.
He's been in office for a year and a half.
I know they give
Bush. We had wars. No, nigga, I was in high school watching this. The towers come down. Forget that. No, I'm done.
Fellow Democrats, like Jamie said, they need to get behind him and support the man, and they do not.
I'm sick of people.
They give college coaches two years to get it together.
Listen. With Barack Obama, we already knew, and if he didn't know this, you know, I know he's too smart to know. Not to know this.
Right.
It's going to be a way tougher sled. It's just like when we worked with the Marines, right? I worked with an African-American Marine. He said, when I had a black Marine come in, I couldn't treat him special. If anything, I had to treat him harder.
Right.
Because of the fact that he was black and they felt like, that I might treat him favorably. We know that Barack Obama is going to have a tougher time. And I will say this. Yeah, the poll numbers are down, but Barack Obama is so similar to William Clinton, President Clinton, because President Clinton's numbers was not... If not low, then lower than what Barack Obama's were his first 2 years.
Right.
I guarantee you the second and the third year of Barack Obama's presidency, by the fourth year, he will be absolutely soaring. Because here's the thing. They don't understand how tough media is. Media is a fun, funny, interesting thing. When media loves you, they love you to death. When they hate you to death. But when they get tired of hating you, what else they got to do? They got to love you again. So they'll love you again. It's Fox O Radio.
Chris Brown is coming back, yes.
Hilarious. Man, this has been crazy. I got to say this, though.
Claudia's a Democrat.
I got to say this.
Damn! Oh, wow.
I got to say this.
Good one, Speedy.
That was a good one.
I got to say this. Something very, very wonderful happened with Foxhole. Huh. Foxhole did something special on this past Sunday.
Yeah.
Foxhole went to Sacramento. And we did the Bobby Jackson Comedy for Cancer, Comedy All-Stars in Sacramento at the Masonic Temple. We put this together in 10 days.
Right.
We did two shows. The first show was actually, they asked why did I suggest put the first show on. I said, listen, we're going to shoot this, and we need sort of a blueprint, a run-through.
What was
amazing about that show is that everybody did their best. The first show was absolutely like, you know, pulling teeth because it was like 5 o'clock, you know. But it was funny because if you really made them people laugh, we knew that the second show was going to be absolutely incredible.
Right.
I got to say this. Kevin Hart. Mm. I called Kevin Hart, and despite
in spite of, despite how great Kevin is doing right now, I mean, he's on the road selling out 4,000-5,000 seats. He's making tons, $250,000.
Just nothing, just whatever. Yeah, we're just out there.
$250,000 a night.
No, we're just getting, you know, just doing the shows.
Let him do it, Kevin. Yeah.
You don't want to get kidnapped.
You're going to be in Soul Plane 3.
$250,000 a night. Hilarious.
So as I walk out, get in the truck, nigga. Not like this, Jesus.
Yeah, not like this. But he's making a lot of money. He's really on his way up. I called Kevin and begged him. I said, listen, man. It's for two good causes. One cause, the Foxhole Radio, and you were trying to do something to put on DVD to make people come out and watch. The second part of it, which is the most interesting part of it, is Comedy for Cancer.
Right.
Which this benefits a lot of breast cancer victims and people that are dealing with that. They absolutely enjoy what you came and did, man. You did two sets. Both of the sets absolutely different.
Right.
Fresh material. I won't give it away, but I just got to say, Pineapples.
Niggas,
the most incredible shit I had ever heard in my life.
Thank you, man.
You did a good job.
I don't think you understand. It was just absolutely amazing, man. And for you to come down, and actually he gave up $100,000 that he was supposed to get, and he came and worked for, you know, all that we could give. Which was, you know, nothing, 50,000, whatever it was. But he came and he worked like he was getting paid, man.
Right.
And everybody that was at the show was tweeting and absolutely enjoyed it, man. So big ups to Kevin Hart.
Off the hook, man. Yeah, man. No problem, dude.
I gotta say, what's my girl name? Coco Brown.
Mm. Right. Coco Brown.
Absolute Speedy.
Speedy.
Even.
It was a shocker.
Speedy was funny. And Lou Dix was great.
Lou Dix was great.
Funny.
Yeah. Wait. Lou Dix was great.
They both.
Can I please tell y'all Speedy's the fucking the Louis Dix joke that they had going backstage? Right.
Well, oh yeah.
Listen, this is the funniest shit I've ever heard. Louis Dix was like stage manager, right? Yeah. So they said Louis was coming back trying to control shit. That was stupid. He said, "Hey, before we go up and do sound checks, does anybody need a left-handed microphone?"
I gotta say this. This show was fucking amazing.
Incredible.
It's my first show directing.
Right.
Along with Deion Taylor.
Great job.
My partner in No Brainer. When I say we kept, and y'all know how hard this is. You know how we do stand up, and it's hard to capture stand up.
Right.
Because it'll be funny in that room.
Right.
And you won't catch none of that. Right. So you'd be like, damn, what the fuck? I thought I was killing right there.
I was there.
Why is it camera angle on the back of my video? Why is it on my hip? I'm back behind the camera, myself and Deion. And Deion Taylor and No Brainer and Roxanne put it together in 10 days.
Right.
Along with the Foxhole, Claudia,
right.
TDP, yeah. Johnny Mack. God Black, Ron Artest. Big up Ron Artest, who was fabulous, man. He came through, did his thing. I gotta say this on the show, and this is gonna come out on DVD under the Foxhole brand for the Foxhole Radio and for No Brainer. Coco Brown became a star.
Yeah, she's hysterical.
She became an absolute star.
Yeah, she killed that second. Yeah.
She killed Smokey.
Oh my God.
Who the first show, I was like, who is this dude? Absolutely smashed.
The Arab guy, too.
Vincent. The Arab guy, Vincent O'Shaughnessy.
Oh, he was hilarious.
Yeah, when I got on the, Spencer knows it. When I got on the phone with Vincent O'Shaughnessy, I said, yo, man, I said, Jamie, let me tell you, Jamie, first of all, let me tell you this. I'm funny than any fucking body you have on a fucking show. Listen, I'm going to go on here and read for this fucking show, whatever it is, called Bones. I never watched it in my life. I'm going to kill the shit. And then I'm going to call you right back because I'm going to make that. So I was thinking, I said, this motherfucker better be good. This dude
is
a star, man. He killed it.
Tony Robbins.
Before I get to that. My man with the
Rob Stapleton
smashed.
Yeah, he killed.
And then last but definitely not least, Tony Roberts, man, who had to come up behind a lot of stuff. Kid and Play Slam.
Yeah.
Lloyd Slam.
Yeah.
We blamed it on the alcohol.
Yeah.
We passed out shots.
Yeah.
We did all of this before Tony Roberts came out, and when he came on stage, he absolutely murdered it. And I mean, it was a lot to come behind. He killed it. The funniest joke to me with Tony Roberts was, this girl's breath was so bad, it smelled like someone was hanging up skunks in her mouth. And he took the mic and was hanging up the skunks, man. Absolutely brilliant show. You will hear about this. Look for it on DVD. We appreciate everybody coming out and supporting. Here's the great thing about it. after the show, I met with some ladies that were suffering from breast cancer.
Right.
And this is what I did, and this is what Claudia is going to help me out with. And Claudia is actually getting ready to launch her show.
Yep.
So look out for Claudia's show, not just on the radio. It's actually going to be filmed. But these are some of the things we're going to tackle. I met some of the ladies that we were talking to about breast cancer.
Uh-huh.
And I got their phone numbers uh-huh. with their husbands, you know, and everything. And I said, listen, this is what I do. I have a young lady who suffers from cancer.
Uh-huh.
On my text message, every other day or every other week, I send her what I call bundles of energy,
uh-huh.
meaning I send her a great positive message. Maybe it'll have a quote for somebody, because you know how you feel. We're really connected to our phones. If we get a great text, we rolling.
Right.
If we get a bad text, we're like, damn, you know.
Right.
So what we're doing is we're going to make a list, and hopefully we'll get everybody in the world that has ever been touched by breast cancer or knows somebody that hasn't, and we're going to start a huge net of sending out positive messages right. to people that have been affected by breast cancer. I just sent my first text to a young lady. I won't say her name on the radio, but she came up to me with her husband, and her husband said, hey, Jamie, you know, my wife is suffering from breast cancer, and immediately we grabbed hands, and I know it's weird, but we did share a prayer in the club.
That's a beautiful thing.
But it was a beautiful thing. I said, you know what, no matter what, we shared a prayer. We got her number. We've already sent a few text messages to her just to let her know that we care. So we'll be doing that. And some of the proceeds from the DVD that we will go out with will benefit breast cancer from here on out. This will be our annual.
Here.
This will be our annual. Every time we do the Foxhole Radio, we will benefit breast cancer in some sort of way, and also other organizations. So this is a great thing, man. Thank you for everybody.
Hey, my mom, 7 years cancer, so she's still with us, and her birthday is April 24th. So we're excited.
Happy birthday.
I love
this good stuff. Also, shout out, man. I got to give Naeem Lynn. He was in there.
Oh my God, I'm tripping.
The dirty baby. The dirty baby.
Listen, Naeem, let me tell you something. The joke, I don't want to give his jokes away, but the joke about if the girl, come on, man, up, say something, man.
Yeah, take Speedy's spot.
Yeah.
Is this Wednesday?
Small head, motherfucker.
Yo,
how,
what up, y'all? Go ahead.
Yo, man, you're first of all, man, absolutely amazing. I'm going to tell you what's great about his set. Every comedian in the world wish we could just stand there and just deliver jokes and have people go crazy. I know I got to every once in a while jump into the crowd. You know what I'm saying? I remember Chris Spence was like, yo, Fox, you ain't got to do that no more. You, Jamie Foxx. I know. To just be able to stand there, man. First of all, how'd you feel, man, doing the show, man?
I felt good, man. I was happy with the opportunity. Shit was off the chain.
Oh, man, it was cool, right?
Yeah,
I mean,
cool.
For a comedian, and I understand, because being a comedian, we knew how to get the room right.
Right.
Because when we first walked
nice
in,
and small.
The room was a little, like, okay. And, but Roxanne and Dion, on the drop of a hat, I can't say enough of them. They went and got the carpet laid down.
Great call.
We laid up the blackout thing, and we made it real intimate. So we will take that model and upgrade it just a little bit. We don't want to go too extravagant, but we would take that model everywhere. So people have already called in San Francisco. People have already called in Atlanta.
Wow.
People have already called in Miami. We talked about this 5 years ago, man. We'd love to have you have a part. I know you're doing a Kevin Hart's thing right
now.
I don't need that shit.
What you got going on?
Shout out to leaving your friends.
That's it. Short-lived.
But here's the thing. Thank you, man. The one joke you know your girl is probably a hoe when she
the head joke.
Yeah, the head joke.
Come on, do it.
Come on, man.
Build your fan base up, man. come on, man.
You don't ruin it for the DVD.
Like on a commercial.
Yeah, dude, this is how you
No, so everybody can not laugh this time.
Whoa.
I'm gonna set myself up.
No.
Speedy would have did it.
No, but here's the thing.
I don't want to be where Speedy is.
There you do. All I can tell you is this, man. Thank you for that. Now, here's the thing. We talked about this for 3 years on this show about actually taking Foxhole out. Now it's official.
Right.
You will now see, because Louis Dix has whispered in my ear, I'm sick of the bullshit. I'm about to blaze the motherfucking mic. So understand that. Louis Dix is coming right now. Understand that. Do y'all understand?
We're not coming.
Louis Dix said he's coming. Speedy was fabulous. I got to say this about Speedy set. Speedy, when he talked about fucking Brian Russell,
oh.
And the hairline with Chico.
But the Brian Russell thing with the push. Oh my God, the Michael Jordan shit. So here's the thing. I know we got to go, but here's the thing. We're getting ready. Great. This show will be going on the road. Thanks to Bo. Okay, shit, you throwing me off.
Getting back on stage. I'm missing all the fun. I'm getting back on stage.
Brandon T. Jackson's getting back on stage.
Yeah, which no one cares.
Okay, that's cool. That's all right.
I'm all right.
But here's the thing. I want to get this out.
Kevin, look out for me, dog. Kevin, look out for me, dog. That's all I'm saying.
I want to get this out. We will be coming to cities. We will be doing shows. The Foxhole Radio Show will do its thing first on that Friday.
Right.
Our show will probably land on that Saturday.
Right.
And we'll probably do some type of celebrity basketball game on that Sunday.
Right.
The All-Stars is coming up. All-Star Weekend's coming. Wow. So Marcus King and everybody else is going to rally around. We're going to make sure that we definitely have a presence during the All-Star in L.A.
Right.
Where we will do a show. We don't know if we want to make it too big. What we may do is scale down places, you know, 4,000, 5,000, maybe the amphitheater, something like that. Maybe the
Yeah, it's weird. That's why I'm performing that tonight. Maybe. It's crazy.
As a matter of fact, let me get right. Kevin Hart will be at the amphitheater tonight. I'm going there. We're going to check it out. It's Kevin Hart. Earthquake. Oh, it's Craig Robinson.
Giovanni, Al Madrigal. It's the
radio station.
Yeah.
But I've just been lying, telling people it's my show.
It's all good. I want to thank. I just got through watching Dead Presidents, and I watched the performance of Bo Peep and Woodbine, which was absolutely amazing. To see him transition from Vietnam all the way over to The Preacher was amazing. I still think Ozzy. And we got some things on the table,
appreciate it,
can really talk about, because we left some stuff on the table. Now we got our companies up and running. We ready to roll. Chris Spencer.
He has
a new movie coming out. Bo King.
What's the name of it?
Oh, yeah. Go see Devil, September 17th.
Look at Fox Face. Look at Jimmy Fox.
What the hell?
Go see Devil, September 17th in the theaters.
I'm going to see that. That shit look crazy, too.
I'm going to see it in my church. I'm going to watch it in church.
Right, I'm happy to see Chris Spencer. We got a lot to talk about, man.
Well, listen, I did two Showtime specials. Yeah. One airs tomorrow at 9 o'clock, where I host it. It's called Chris Spencer Presents the Minority Report. So I bring up three comics. Hilarious. And then my other special will be out in October. Chris Spencer, the other Chris.
Wow. Amazing. And we will ask Chris Spencer to come and do the Foxhole show. Brandon T. Jackson's new movie is on his way.
Lottery ticket is out today.
Go
see it. Yes, sir. Make it track everywhere, guys.
Girl on UConn and 105th.
Support black film.
I'm going to be there.
Yeah, I'm going. I'm going to go see it right now. I got to say this, man. I'm so excited. We got a lot of shit moving right now. I still want to thank everybody that came out for the sketch show. We launching that sketch show that's coming out. Afion Crockett, Jonathan Kite Blaze, Samantha Nagel Blaze, Erica Ash Blaze. Samantha's off.
Jamie, when we were all hanging out
Samantha's off.
Yeah. No, like
I wanted to knock her out. Yeah, Samantha's off. Right?
Yeah, Samantha, she's a little crazy.
No, yeah. Samantha, I said, Samantha, can you talk in your regular voice? What do you mean you got to talk in my regular voice?
Of course I can.
But let it rock.
She's a lot of energy.
She will not stop doing characters. Remind me of Anthony Hopkins with the dummy.
she knows every hip-hop lyric, too.
She knows every fucking... It's crazy. Man, we could do hours. Listen, it's a brand new thing going on. No Brainer is doing things, man. Foxhole's doing things. Man, Fox Kings, man. We doing it, man. We on another level. We will see y'all. Look, when I look to the right of me, I see my friend who's got himself together, Chris Barron.
He's a vegan.
He's a vegan now.
Love
he's
you,
coming
boy.
To get his thing back. When I look to the left, oh, I see you, Zoe. I see you, Zoe, man.
Oh,
the wizard, the mind of
Brian Impossible.
What is it? What's the name of the show?
Voice of Reason.
The Voice of Reason. Yeah. I said Voice of Reason.
It's only on your network.
It's been on for years.
I just called it the Wizard.
I see Beverly Hills Opportunity. It's a balmy 85. Shout out to all my Leos. Happy birthday. We about to get it in. It's going down. When I die, heaven better be off the chain. Because I'm having a ball. Foxhole Radio. We out.